W. I don't know if you caught the Stephen F. Austin game last night, but a buzzer beater as it leaves his hands, and watching Stephen F. Austin get into the tournament last night, which was exciting. You got Marquette and the Badgers getting ready to get their tournaments, respective tournaments underway. You've got some more Brewers baseball coming up today. You've got movement in NFL free agency, and we can discuss that. There's a lot of stuff going on. Welcome to the program on a rainy day today. And if you're watching on the live stream, you can see what I'm talking about. The rain is falling and has been for quite some time, heavier at times than others as we start to kind of head back into our what should be our regular this time of year mode, so to speak. We've been pretty lucky temperature wise all the way up until this point, so not a terrible thing, but not great to be going back into the cooler weather, but that's okay. We know we've been blessed so far this off season at least for those that don't like the extreme cold. Now for those that needed the weather, yeah, you've taken a beating this year, and that's not an easy way to go. So at our pleasure, you have taken a financial beating, so hang in there. 877-867-1670, 877-867-1670. You can find us if you want to get a hold of us that way. You can also track us down over on X on Twitter, @Bill_Michaels. Grant Bill standing by @WiscoGrant. You can catch his stuff there. You've got Facebook. Go to Facebook.com/TheBillMichaelsShow. You can watch us on Facebook. You can see everything we do over on Instagram, Instagram.com/TheBillMichaelsShow. YouTube, a great way to pay attention to the program. That is YouTube.com/BillMichaelsShow. MICHAELS, three words, put them all together. Same thing over on Twitch TV on the Twitch app and on the Kick app as well. You can find us on LinkedIn. Same thing on TikTok. And if you want to email the program, it's simply TheBillMichaels@gmail.com. And then there is the website, which is simply TheBillMichaels.com. That's TheBillMichaels.com. And the Zone app out of Madison, our flagships, the mighty flagship station. It is WOZN, the Zone Madison, the Zone Madison. You can find us there. And then after the fact on Apple iTunes, Google Podcasts, Spotify, all those kind of good platforms, so to speak. Grant, how you doing today?
Doing good. Pretty dreary drive in, so that'll kill the vibes a little bit. And then we got to talk about the Brewers All-Star closer missing a couple of months. That'll kill the vibes.
Yeah, that's a kick to the beans.
It is. A kick to the huevos, yeah. Certainly.
Yeah. Tom, good morning in South Dakota. Ethan, Rick, and everybody that's over on the live stream, good to have you. Well, that's kind of where we start today, that the Brewers get the word that, yeah, this is not what you were hoping for. This was not the news that you were looking for, that your main guy, the most important piece, the Brewers pitching staff, will not be throwing a pitch at all. Kurt Hogue with the story in today's Journal Sentinel, as D.O. Hall follows through on his delivery, kicking a left foot in the air. He says, you've still got the voice of Chris Hook saying, hey, guys, you know, how are you doing? That type of thing. But nevertheless, you're not going to have Devin Williams. Will now miss the next 3 months with a stress fractures. Plural. Stress fractures in his back. The Brewers, for the past 5 years, have relied heavily on a core of young homegrown starters to fuel the string of winning baseball, have largely a different cast of characters standing on the mound this year. And that's the challenge that's now ahead of him. But Devin Williams, 3 months with stress fractures in his back. I said, yesterday or the day before, we were talking about Brewers baseball and Devin Williams. And I said, anytime you have to go see a spine specialist, it's not good. What you're hoping for is that it's precautionary and to eliminate things. But anytime you're going to see a specialist in a second opinion, it's not good. And they found stress fractures in his back, which would mean his vertebrae. You would assume it's his vertebrae. And you talk about taking the wind out of your sails. Oh, you know, we were kind of like almost, you know, the knock on wood thing where the Brewers really haven't had any major injuries in camp. You know, nothing, you know, and I was thinking it. I didn't say it. I was thinking it, but they really haven't. They hadn't been banged up. And then you get a little bit of soreness and you're like, man, what's going on? And now the question becomes, if these stress fractures, if he's going to be able to return, you know, I mean, what I want to know, Grant, is what caused it? Just merely pitching, or is there something else going on? You know what I mean? Because what's to prevent him from coming back and then it happening again?
I don't know. You know, little, you know, mechanical things where you're tweaking your shoulder an inch too far this way. Like, they break all these things down to the split second on these high def cameras and stuff in their pitching labs. I don't know, man. Throwing a baseball is really, really violent. Sometimes I'm more surprised when these guys stay healthy for an entire year than I am when they get hurt. Honestly, it's so tough on your body.
It is an absolute violent controlled chaos is what pitching is. It's like a golf swing. It is a violent controlled chaos. And I hate to say that this is like the death knell, but stress fractures stress fractures in your back, unless, because there's only so much, you either have the ribs, the cartilage, and the spine. That's it. It's not like you have a bunch of bones back there that are additional. That's it. So you either have stress fractures in portions of your vertebrae or where the ribs meet the spine. One of the two. And at this point, I'm like, and I know this. This is, and I don't want to say this. And I don't want to be the Debbie Downer. But this is bad. When you have pain like that and stress fractures like that, I don't know how you recover from that. I don't know. Unless there was something like maybe he did, like he was deadlifting or something, or he was squatting and that's how it happened. Okay. Then you can say, you know what? Then you're not. But if it happened because of the violence that is the throwing of a baseball, I don't know how you recover from that. Because I don't know how you withstand this at your age and then say, okay, I'm going to come back and I'm going to have a sustained career because of it. I don't know. I mean, I want to hear more, but man, I just, that was a kick to the crotch. No doubt. That was like holy mackerel. So I am not in any way, shape, or form going to count on Devin Williams to be the closer of this team. Now you got to find one, whether it's Piamps or somebody else that happens to emerge that comes up with good stuff. I don't know. But, oh, what a blow. What a tough blow. So that's the way we kind of started today, was reading that this morning and going, oh, crap. So that's the reason it's raining and it looks kind of gloomy outside.
It is a bummer. I'm calling it now that at the trade deadline, the Brewers aren't going to make a move big enough to make most Brewers fans happy. And then Matt Arnold's going to go to a microphone and say, but we're getting Devin Williams back, which is essentially like acquiring an all-star closer at the trade deadline. Because that's always what happens when you get a star player back around that time. You can mark that down.
Well, I'm kind of like, how... That's tough, man. When you lose your closer is too mild a term for Devin Williams because he's been that good. When he's been the guy that just locks the door and doesn't let anybody in for the most part. And I mean, he's not been perfect, but he's been as close to it as you can get, as one of the most dominant closers in baseball. I mean, they went from hater to him. And you would love to have known this a month and a half ago, when you still had some guys sitting, and a guy like Hader still sitting out in the open market, you know, you would have loved to have known this. But like I said, I'm hoping, if I have to say, I'm hoping for something, I'm hoping that he heard it doing squats or deadlifts and not the violence of the actual motion of pitching. And here's the other thing. When you talk about, well, it's a tweak here or there, if you then take away the movement and the motion that has been his pitch, then you begin to move spin and rotation and movement on his pitches because of the lack of movement in his body, because it's the whole motion that creates the movement. And the snap of the wrist, the twist of the wrist, the rolling off of the fingers, the way the pitch is thrown, the way the arm comes down, everything. If you move that, then you've got a really good chance of risking his dynamicness and eliminating that to where he becomes, he can still maybe hurl it up there at 96, 97, 98 miles an hour, but it doesn't have movement. It's throwing it on a string and it becomes much more hittable at that point. You know, now I think you have to look at the human element side of things and you have to say, man, you hope he's going to be okay and he's going to be able to live a quality of life after baseball. But in the immediate, when you get the kick to the crotch, as a baseball fan, you're thinking, boy, you would really, really, really like to have him just get healed up and be back in a couple of months. But you're going to lose him for April, May, and June. You're not even going to think about it. I would say my suspicion is if all goes well, you see him just after the All-Star break. If it doesn't go well, I wouldn't count on him in 2024. Just my take. So disappointing day if you're a Brewers fan. And maybe that might take you out of the, like I was saying, 85, 86, 87 range. That's going to drop you down at least a few games, right? Maybe that becomes, so you lose Burns and lose your closer. Okay. Now your closer's in more games. So you lose your you know, Burns and your closer in a part of Woodruff. Okay. Now you're starting the descent, and that's not a good thing. Not a good thing. 877-867-1670. If you want to chime in, do it again. 877-867-1670. I would love to hear from you and to get your thoughts as to what you think Devin Williams means to this team. And Devin Williams, if you're just tuning us in, stress fractures in his back, which means kind of like his spine. And he is down now for at least 3 months. At least 3 months. So give us a shout there. 877-867-1670. You can find us if you want to hit us up via email. You can. We're going to talk to Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show, a little bit later on today about this and kind of get his thoughts because he's probably feeling it today. Zach Heilprin is going to join us from the Big Ten Tournament. We'll talk with him also about the Badgers as they get ready to effort in to the Big Ten Tournament as well. So we'll talk to both of those guys. You got college basketball aplenty, back at it. Conference tournaments pick it up again today. Any news breaking in free agency, we'll go ahead and jump all over that as well. Don't do anything. Don't go anywhere. Stay tuned. We got a whole lot more of the Bill Michaels Show. It's all coming up right after this. Stay right there.
Covering Wisconsin sports like a blanket, this is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Make it a real Mad March with a playoff payout at Pottawatomie. Every week, you could score your share of 100 grand in cash and free play. Play this March for drawing entries. Win each Thursday. Plus, the prizes refresh every week for even more winners. The playoff payout at Pottawatomie, Milwaukee. It's anyone's game. For more details, visit paysbig.com/payout. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote. We take the time to listen and educate you on all your product options. And with Design Works, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Whether you're looking to replace your windows due to damage or it's time for a refresh and you'd like to revitalize your home style, choosing from Pella's wide range of windows and doors will complement your home's unique design. Pella can also customize, providing nearly endless possibilities for maximum design flexibility with dramatic sizes, custom colors, finishes, profiles, product types, and more. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes.
We'll be right back.
Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Michael's show continuing on. Hey, there's a good company out there. If you've seen it, I saw it when I was over at Skipper Bud's the other day. I know they're in numerous motorcycle shops, RV shops, automobile detailers. That's called Wabam, W-A-B-A-M. Go to getwabam.com and see all the products they have to offer, but really good stuff from Wabam. And I use it all the time on my motorcycle, and there's many different products, whether it's glass cleaner, detailers, stuff that, you know, keeps the bugs and such from sticking to the paint of your car. It protects your, it kind of seals your paint. So there's so much stuff that you can get, and that's getwabam.com, getwabam.com. Coming up today, you've got a lot of different stuff going on. You've got earlier today in the 1 o'clock hour, Wisconsin's in the Big Ten tournament. They take on Maryland today. So they're hoping to get a win. Coming up tonight, you got the Bucks and the 76ers. That's 7 o'clock down at the Fi Serve. And then Madison Square Gardens, 8:30 this evening. You've got Villanova and Marquette in the Big East tournament. So some things going on more of note around here, as far as games that matter, so to speak. So, and then, like I said, coming up in about an hour and 10 minutes from now, we're going to talk with Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show. And we'll talk with him as you woke up this morning and found out that Devin Williams, the reliever for the Milwaukee Brewers, the closer, he is out 3 months with stress fractures in his back. And they're hoping those will heal. And I mean, obviously he's, you know, I don't know what you can do for it. I don't know what therapy wise you can do for it, but I got to think, you know, there's something he's going to be doing or not doing. Maybe it's just rest and relaxation and see what happens. But he started having some pain in his back here a couple of weeks ago, as a matter of fact, in spring training. Did you get a sense that he was ailing that bad, Grant, when you were out there?
No, I didn't notice anything, but I had no preconceived notions getting down there. It's like, how's Devin doing? No, we knew nothing. Saw him a couple times, looked fine. A couple reporters checked in with him. I think it started as a small thing they expected to go away, and then it didn't go away, which is why it came to a head this week.
Right. So they sent him out. Remember, they gave him the X-ray, and then they sent him out for the MRI. And then once that all came back, it was like, oh, okay, yeah, there's some issues. So that's what today's news was, is the fact that he is indeed ailing and will not be able to participate for 3 months. Ugh. I haven't looked since the injury came out. Has anything changed when it comes to the Vegas looking at them going wins and losses wise? Did you happen to see if anything changed?
I guess I didn't check. What were, because we talked about this yesterday. What was it at yesterday for the Brewers?
70. It went up one win, 77.5.
I was going to say it went up just slightly, right?
Right.
Let me see if I can find anything. The one I'm looking at right now is still 77.5. Let me dig a little deeper.
Okay. Yeah. If you see something, let me know. But otherwise, I can't. I mean, that to me is more detrimental almost than losing Corbin Burns. I mean, Corbin Burns ate up innings and was solid, gave you a legitimate shot at winning a ball game every time he went to the hill. Whereas Devin Williams, he was the guy that closed for the win and was brought in the win situations and closed it out. So that's why that is so tough. And I think it's even more devastating than losing Burns or Woodruff. Not losing both, but yeah.
Do you think for this team, they're better equipped to handle a 3-month injury to Devin Williams or to Freddie Peralta?
Whew, that's a great question.
Because their bullpen is deeper.
Yeah.
They have more continuity there.
Yeah. I just don't know. I think it would be handling a starter because I don't know if they have anybody that dynamic in the back that they could just automatically switch into the back end of the bullpen. And Uribe, for as hard as he throws, we talked about this earlier this year, he doesn't throw for strikeouts. And sometimes as a closer, you need strikeouts. If you get into trouble, you got to be able to, sit people down. Now, the other guy you could think about, and I know they want to use him as a starter, but a guy that throws hard is Mizorowski. If he would develop into something, would that be the guy? Could he eventually find himself working his way up to the bigs and given a shot to go in and close a ball game or two?
So that's an interesting possibility. I don't think he's in their major league plans until later on in the year. But then again, Joey Weimer wasn't in their major league plans last year.
Right.
So all of a sudden he needed to be.
Right.
So I can't imagine this changes Mizorowski's trajectory right now. But in a month or two,
right,
I'd be thinking, man, we need elite arms in the back end of the bullpen. If Uribe can't throw strikes or if they deal with another injury, that could be a trickle down effect in the future. Absolutely.
Yep. And that might be the way to go. If indeed he can kind of work himself into that. But that was my first thought, was who throws hard, who throws with movement. And from everything we heard coming out of camp, Mizorowski would be that guy. Now, he's never played in the majors, so I don't think that you go from, taking a guy out of minor leagues and throwing him right into a closer's role with the pressure of Major League Baseball on him. I don't know if you'd necessarily do that. I don't know if he's mentally equipped to handle that. I don't know him. But that's a guy that has all the tools to do that. Now, Uribe is a guy that throws hard. He can get it up there at 100 miles an hour, but he's not a big strikeout guy. And he would have to be if you're going to be a closer. You got to be a strikeout guy. So, but yeah, that's definitely an area of concern. Like I said, we'll talk with Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show, about that coming up here in about an hour from now. Oh, speaking of, things that you got to find out and possibly, losing things. How about Atlanta? Are the Atlanta Falcons interested? Did you hear the press conference with Kirk Cousins?
Do we need to play some of it on the show? I think we might have. I saw clips, but I honestly thought they were memes, and then I realized that it's real.
What is real is he admitted to having contact with the head strength and conditioning coach, I think, or the trainer throughout the process prior to the legal tampering period. And that's a no-no. You can't do that. They were already talking about how how he could set up his workouts and whatever. And you can't do that. because he wasn't their property at that point in time. Because technically, you know, you can't start talking to people until they give you the, quote, legal tampering period. So I saw that this morning. As a matter of fact, Paul Georgian had posted something about it regarding the Vikings, that they need to jump on this because you're not, that's a huge no-no in that world. So, but yeah, Kirk Cousins kind of like let the cat out of the bag inadvertently to say, yeah, I've been talking to these guys for a while now.
It's not a no-no to do it. It's a no-no to say it, because all these teams probably on some level do it. You know what
right,
I mean?
Right.
But to say it out loud at the press conference, the Falcons are like, dude, what are you doing? You didn't need to do that.
He had, like I said, I'm sure he's, you know, by the time it left his lips, he probably went, oh crap, you know. But yeah, that's a no-no. You can't do that. That was outside of the legal tampering period, which could land the Atlanta Falcons in a heap of trouble. Isn't that Atlanta's way, though? They finally get themselves a legit quarterback since Matt Ryan had the Super Bowl run. And now they could be subject to fines and losing draft choices and all that kind of stuff. So it's, you know, just you can't take two steps forward without taking a couple back if you're Atlanta. So at least they're happy they got a quarterback. So that was something that came out as well. Now, do you have him talking at his presser?
I don't. I can get the clip. Yeah. I just need a couple minutes to dig.
Yeah, let's do that. We'll do that. We'll get Kirk Cousins doing his introductory. Hey, I'm a Atlanta Falcon. I can retire here in Atlanta. And of course, his wife's from down there, so it made a lot of sense. But you know, come on. Nobody retires to Atlanta. Just saying. 877-867-1670. If you want to find us, please feel free. Go ahead and do so. Again, 877-867-1670. Find us. Hit us up. We'd love to hear from you. This portion of the program brought to you by our friends over there at Epoxy Flooring Done Right. Sean and the gang, think about it this way. The winter wasn't terrible, but there was some sand. There's, you know, like today, you've got rain and the dirt from the streets and such coming into your garage, or maybe you've got a basement floor that you want to get done. Whatever it is, whether it's, say, just flat out epoxy flooring, polyurea coating, or that coating that makes it look like it's marbleized, that's just beautiful, you know, and easy to clean and all that kind of stuff, they can do it all. And all you got to do is check out Sean and the gang, 262-443-2852, from Green Bay to Milwaukee, out to Madison, everywhere in between. That's Epoxy Flooring Done Right. EpoxyFlooringDoneRight.com. EpoxyFlooringDoneRight.com. Or call Sean directly, 262-443-2852. 262-443-2852. Tell them we sent you. And by the way, they paint as well. So if you're going to get a whole room done, a whole basement done, whatever, if you want the floor done, they can even paint the room for you. So you can get a really good price on that because they're already doing the epoxy stuff. So get a hold of them again, epoxyflooringdoneright.com, or call them 262-443-2852.
Covering Wisconsin sports like a blanket, this is the Bill Michael Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Bill Michaels will resume in 5 minutes. Michaels will resume in 4 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Bill Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Was out at Social House over the weekend. Kristen and I stopped in and had a bite to eat. They had some music that started. And their Sunday music series is always good. It's always fun. It's always amazing to me how many people come out on a Sunday for Sunday Fun Day and just hang out. And I would assume over the next couple of weeks specifically, it's going to be crazy for the fact that you're going to have the tournaments going on and basketball happening, and then eventually baseball is going to be starting. Dan already does a great job with golf and having just about every sport there is up on the tube. But then they have the music series, and it's just, it's good food, good place, good people. I told you the other day that I actually had something different. I didn't have the Tiger Burger. I did, had the what they call the Nashville Chicken Sandwich, which is this, it's really, really good. It's like a crispy chicken sandwich, but it's got a special glaze and everything on it. It was fantastic. We had a great time. Always do. Always have a great time there. And it's about the people more than anything. But that's the Social House, H-A-U-S, on Lisbon Road, Menominee Falls. And stop in, tell them all we said hi. So great to have them on board as a sponsor, and has been for a long time. So by the way, Skinny from Madison says, hey, Bakhtiari's not been picked up on anybody yet. Is that bad news for him on the injury front? I don't expect him to be. I don't think you could even think about picking up David Bakhtiari yet, because he has not been even cleared. This is what I think happens. Bakhtiari begins to really talk to teams come July, and then we'll see if he can't find his way into a camp somewhere. Or what could happen is that he could end up sitting out for the first month of the season. And then if somebody's got a tackle that goes down, which it happens, then they can pick him up. But until he can do everything football related, and because remember, Brian Gutekunst said he didn't even think he would be cleared to participate until after, you know, like once training camp got going. Well, who's going to pay him a lot of money or bring him in right now? Nobody's going to do that. It's probably going to be well after June before somebody gives him a look, unless he's really far ahead of schedule from that fourth surgery. So, but no, I don't think anybody's going to pick Bakhtiari up yet. No. This was Kirk Cousins making some of the statements at his initial presser that raised the eyebrows of some Vikings fans. Take a listen.
I'm going to be the same guy I've been through that whole process, and I believe that what's gotten me here to this point will serve me well up ahead. And you don't do it alone. And you got to do it with the people around you. And again, that's why when you get here and you look around, you think, boy, there's great people here. And it's not just the football team. I mean, I'm looking at the support staff, calling our head athletic trainer, talking to our head of PR. I'm thinking we got good people here. And that's exciting to be a part of.
He goes on to say that he did have some conversations prior to with the head trainer, which, because that was the follow-up question, was you've already talked to the trainer, and then he kind of made the announcement that he'd been talking to some of those people. And that's what raised the eyebrows and the ears of those up in Minnesota. But I think it's going to end up being all for naught. But, you know, now we'll wait and see. But it doesn't matter to me, because I think, first of all, I don't think Minnesota was going to pay him. I just don't think they were. I don't think they wanted to go in that direction. They've spent a lot of money. They paid him a lot of money. They've said all the right things about bringing him back, but Atlanta wanted him more. And I don't think they were willing to pay that, because they know they don't have a Super Bowl team right now. They know that. So I'm not too worried about what Minnesota thinks at this point anyway. I think it's going to be an incredibly competitive NFC South. Baker Mayfield had a solid year last year. I don't know what they're going to end up doing down in New Orleans. They're still trying to climb out of salary cap jail down there. And then, obviously, Atlanta has gotten better. You got to think that Carolina is going to get better, right? You got to think at some point things are going to start to turn around for them, that, you know, maybe they won't be this bad again. But you got to think that Carolina is going to have some improvement. So I'm just kind of interested to see how now the power shifts down to the NFC South. And if the NFC South is good enough, do they get one or two teams in to the postseason, which obviously would eliminate a team from another division? So would it be then the AFC East or the North or the West? Who then loses that extra team? If, say, Kirk Cousins can take them to 10 or 11 wins and Baker Mayfield does the same for Tampa Bay, who then is the odd man looking out? So, you know, while it may not really impact us a lot, you know, as far as the schedule goes, it could impact as far as the ability, because they also can beat up on each other down there. It may impact the ability to get an extra wild card team in, which is why, you know, you want to win the division, because then you can at least guarantee yourself a spot in the postseason. Otherwise, you're fighting with everybody else. So while it may not seem like a big deal, it still could be a big deal. Still could be a big deal. 877-867-1670, 877-867-1670. And this one's from Al. Al says, man, what a disappointment to hear about Devin Williams this morning. I know that he was ailing a little bit, but I didn't expect something like that. I thought it would be just a couple of weeks and he'd be right back at it. What do you think this does to their win total, and who now becomes the front runner in the National League Central? I think I don't think there's any clear-cut winner right now. If you had to sit here and put your finger on it, I don't think there's a clear-cut winner. I think that Cincinnati, if they get pitching, they can hit the hell out of baseball. The Brewers are going to be, I think, fun to watch. And you're going to have to get out of the young guys what you got out of the young guys last year. And you're going to have to see more out of Christian Yelich and more out of Rhys Hoskins, the same out of Contreras, you know, and the same level, if not better, defense than what they played with last year. And, you know, then pitching is just going to have to be, you know, it's going to have to step up. I that's such a cliche thing to say. I don't know how else to say it, but you're going to have to get a couple of surprises. Basically, you're going to have a healthy season. You can't have Freddie go down. You can't have Miley down for an extended period of time. And you got to get Miley from a couple of years ago and not the Wade Miley that was coming out of Cincinnati. You know, that you just you need things to fall into place. I think the Cubs are a question mark. How much does Craig Counsell give them? I already talked about Cincinnati. St. Louis is the wild card. St. Louis could be awful, or they could just come out and set the world on fire and be the St. Louis Cardinals again. And I think they're, you know, the Cardinals are never usually an X factor, but this year I think they're the X factor. So do I have a clear-cut winner? I still think the Brewers can do it. I think they're going to be right there. But I don't, as far as winning the division goes, I don't know. But, it's disappointing to see. No doubt. This is from Ricky. Ricky says, other guys in the back end of the bullpen are just going to simply have to, as I said, step up. He says that there's a couple of guys back there that have at least decent junk, and maybe they can go closer by committee. That's not the most ideal thing, but at least for the next couple of months, that's probably going to be the way it goes until somebody begins to emerge. I'm not devastated by the news, but it certainly does hurt. Ricky, appreciate the email. Ricky, by the way, listening to us up in Manitowoc. Good to hear from Manitowoc. Good stuff. And then there's this one from Jeff. Jeff is listening to us up in Green Bay. Says, first and foremost, I think the Packers have done amazing things to better themselves. I think they're better on paper now than they were at this point in time last year. And we all know what their productivity can be. So we understand that this team is going to get better. And in Goody, I trust. If he hits on four or five guys in the draft, this team is more than fortified. We are on our way. As far as the Brewers go, I never thought the Brewers would win more than 84 or 85 games and be on the outside looking in. Anyway, this doesn't really hurt my thoughts of them going to the postseason. It's going to be a one-year one-off, and then they will retool and be back. But it just is sad to see a guy so young go down with such an injury that could devastate him for the rest of his life. Well, let's hope it's not that, Jeff. Let's hope it's not that. And thanks for listening to us, by the way, up in Green Bay. But let's hope it's not that. Let's hope it's just something that is kind of a freak thing and it heals and he's fine and things are good. You know, cross your fingers. That's all you can do. Like I said, coming up in less than an hour, about 45 minutes from now, Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show, is going to join us. We'll talk with Tim about this, too. I'm sure Tim's devastated. Being the Brewers fan that he is, I'm sure he's a little bit devastated. Let's do this. We'll step out. We'll take a quick break. We'll come back. We got a lot more to get to. This portion of the program brought to you by our friends over there at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. And at Pella, they got all kinds of good stuff. First of all, they have got great windows, great doors, and whether it's something for your budget like vinyl or impervia or the different styles and lines of wood windows, they've got modern, they've got contemporary, they've got old style, old school type of windows as well, hardware, different innovations, exterior, interior, all of that. Beautify your house, make it more valuable. I can go on and on. But you can also, which is the best part about this, you can get them now, get them out, get that free in-home consultation and find out what, you know, different lines, different options and things like that, what's best suits you. And then you can get up to 0% financing for 60 months. That's what they've been offering, and it's fantastic. Get a hold of our friends at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. And, oh, by the way, I don't know if you knew this, but they have a new showroom up in the Stevens Point, Wausau area. So if you're in that area and you've been kind of neglected because you've had to go a long way to find, the authorized Pella dealer, Pella is now there. So you don't have to go searching anymore, going to home improvement shops anymore. Call Pella directly. They have a spot up there to help you out as well. Go to PellaWI.com. That is Pella, P-E-L-L-A, PellaWI.com, or call them 855-PellaWI, 855-PellaWI. So if you're in Marshfield, if you're in Stevens Point, if you're in Tomahawk, if you're in Wausau, any Plover, any one of those areas, just give them a buzz, and they can help you out up in there, that area, too. They've got a showroom now up there. Stay tuned. We got more of the Bill Michaels Show coming up next.
Covering Wisconsin sports like a blanket, this is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote. We take the time to listen and educate you on all your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Whether you're looking to replace your windows due to damage or it's time for a refresh and you'd like to revitalize your home style, choosing from Pella's wide range of windows and doors will complement your home's unique design. Pella can also customize, providing nearly endless possibilities for maximum design flexibility with dramatic sizes, custom colors, finishes, profiles, product types, and more. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes. Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Bill Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Thursday, but it's joyful inside. I'll tell you why coming up in a minute. Gotta say thanks to our friends at the Water Doctors. Water Doctors been with us now for more than a few years and a big supporter of Fisher House, Wisconsin, and also our motorcycle ride coming up on Sunday, September 1st, which I can't wait till we can unveil all the details, which is probably going to be the first week of April. But I'm really looking forward to being able to say, hey, guess what? And we're really excited about it. But they're a big supporter. And they also, oh, by the way, have the best water softening system on the market. And that is the Connecticut water softening system. So much so, I have it in my house. I've had it for years, over 20 years. I've had, it's only been two systems because the warranty on these things are like 10 years. I mean, they're fantastic. But I put an updated one in my house about a year ago after 18, 19 years of having a Connecticut system in my house. And it's just because I love drinking water that is clean and pure. And, you know, everybody talks about how good you feel coming out of the shower or your clean clothes and stuff. But to me, it's all about drinking water because I drink so much of it. But the Connecticut water softening system is fantastic. Go to H2O doctors.com. That's H2O doctors.com. Again, H2O doctors.com. Or simply call John and his staff, John Attlee and his staff. 262-549-7733. 262-549-7733. Give them a shout and they can help you. It doesn't matter where in the state of Wisconsin you are, they can help you. 262-549-7733. That is the Water Doctors. And they're just really, really good people. Very philanthropic and do a lot for veterans and veteran community. Heck yeah. 877-867-1670. If you want to find us, please feel free. Go ahead and do so again. 877-867-1670. Justin says the back end of the bullpen is going to be bullpen by committee. I think Piamps can step up. Last year, he got out of many major situations only to pass it off to Devin Williams. So I would give Piamps a legitimate shot at getting the deal done. Uribe would be a good guy if he can get some more movement on his fastball. Right now, he's throwing it on a BB. And he also says that if this year Christian Yelich and Hoskins can both hit 25 to 30 home runs, that might make up for some of the loss of pitching that this team has seen over the last couple of months. And that's from Justin. I don't know if just those two guys can make up for the loss of Corbin Burns and now Devin Williams, but boy, I tell you what, if those two guys can give you those kind of power numbers and the guys around them are getting on base, if we see the same type of offensive output, same type of play out of Garrett Mitchell, out of Sal Frelick, you know, a little bit better out of Joey Weimer, obviously Bryce Terang, you know, all of that, which, by the way, coming up after the top of the hour, you're going to hear a little bit from Bryce Terang from yesterday. But if you can get more out of the same or better out of those guys and a few more power numbers out of Christian Yelich, out of Rhys Hoskins, yeah, then I would go right along with that. Then I wouldn't really adjust too much my win total. But you it's a blow. It just is. And you also, you know, you wonder how that affects everybody else, knowing that the guy that was your shutdown, lockdown closer, one of the best, if not the best in baseball over the last couple of years, you just wonder what that does mentally to a team that goes, oh, you know, now we're not even out of the chute yet, and we've already sustained this kind of a major blow. You know, it's bad enough when you knew you were going to lose. You knew what was coming with Corbin Brandon Woodruff. You knew he wasn't going to be back. But you knew, you know, here you go. You lose Corbin Burns, and you knew it was a business. And then now you lose one of your – you had really a three- or four-headed monster, right? You had Corbin Burns, Brandon Woodruff. You can throw in Freddy Peralta because he was pretty stable. And then you knew the back end of the bullpen with Devin Williams. You had four solid pitchers, right? And now three of the four are gone. That is a blow. So, you know, knock on wood that they can find somebody. But, man, it's going to be tough without a doubt. He also goes on to talk about, I don't want to get into that. Aaron says, what do you feel about the Packers making another move? I still think they need a middle linebacker unit. There's a couple of guys on the market, but I wouldn't overpay to get one. I don't necessarily think Goody's a bad drafter. I think that you can't just jump in and be a starting middle linebacker in the National Football League and expect, and then he's got parentheses, as a rookie, to come in and be that impactful. Losing Devin Williams is a huge blow. I say it makes 7 to 8 games difference for this team. So you're saying if I'm saying an 80-win season or an 87-win season, 86-win season, now they're at 78, 79? You know, now, for the people that said, oh, I told you 77, 78 wins, you were saying that prior to Devin Williams going down. You know, with each injury, you can't go up. Told you so. You know, because on paper, no, that's not going to happen. You know, that's like if I came out and said, you know, hey, I think they're only going to win. Packers are going to win 10 games this year, you know, and then, oh, by the way, all of a sudden there's two or three wide receivers that, you know, come out of the open market and the Packers go, nobody else wants them. We'll take them. And then they have eight weapons and they can throw to everybody. And this aerial circus happens and they win 10, 11 games. I can't go, see, I told you so. I can't do that. You can't do that now either. You know, if you thought it was going to be 82, 83 wins, Devin Williams would then seemingly adjust that. If you thought it was going to be 75 to 77 wins, then you should adjust your win total to say, well, now I believe they're only going to win 73, 74, 72, whatever it happens to be. So it's just too easy to say, see, I told you so sometimes. What else here? Got a lot of people sending emails in today. I appreciate it. I really do. Appreciate a lot of the emails. Steve says, good day, unit. What a dreary, craptacular day. I'm telling myself that it could be worse and we could be shoveling snow instead. Some thoughts. First of all, Brewers, can Mizorowski be the closer? Although he hasn't pitched in the majors, it's a highly regarded prospect. I could be wrong, but I thought that when Dan Plesac went to the closer's role and he had not thrown a pitch in the majors. And if that's the case, I don't see why Mizorowski can't. I think that if Mizorowski isn't the answer, then I'm sure that Matt Arnold will find a diamond in the rough somewhere. And he's got more with Packers and Bucks and such going on. So we'll read the rest of that when we come back. And also when we come back, you're going to hear from Bryce Terang, the second baseman of the Milwaukee Brewers. So you're going to hear from him. Bottom of the hour, Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show in Milwaukee, is going to join us. We'll talk with him about the injury to Devin Williams and the Brewers in general. We'll get into that discussion coming up in about an hour and a half. You got our guy, Zach Heilprin, is going to join us. We'll talk about Wisconsin's effort into the Big Ten tournament. And we'll get some thoughts from him down at the tournament. And we got a lot more coming up. Don't go anywhere. A whole lot more of the Bill Michaels Show. Stay right where you're at. We'll be back right after this.
This is a Wisconsin Sports Zone update.
Well, the Badgers know who they will take on in the Big Ten tournament today. After beating Rutgers 65-51 last night, the Maryland Terrapins have advanced for the right to take on Wisconsin today at 1:30 at the Target Center in Minnesota. Now, the Badgers have gone 3-8 since February 1st. One of those three wins did come against Maryland. And Greg Gard says, despite their woes, his team hasn't flinched.
They haven't flinched and felt sorry for themselves. They understand, you know, this is part of it, part of the journey. You know, continue to get yourself out of the, you know, predicament you're in, and continue to get better. And the next 40 minutes is what we need to focus on.
Again, tip off the day between the Badgers and the Terrapins is at 1:30. Turning to the Bucks, they went 1-3 in their West Coast road trip. That put them to 42-24 overall. They're tied for second now with the Cavaliers in the East, 9.5 games behind the Boston Celtics. The Bucks do come back home today, though, as they'll take on the Philadelphia 76ers at the Pfizer Forum. Tip-off, that's at 7 o'clock.
Rural Mutual Insurance, keeping Wisconsin strong.
As a proud sponsor of the WIAA, Rural Mutual roots for all of Wisconsin's student athletes. Whether they're a hometown hero or they dream of the national spotlight, sportsmanship keeps Wisconsin strong. Visit ruralmutual.com/WIAA to learn more about how they support high school athletics.
Rural Mutual Insurance, keeping Wisconsin strong.
Well, free agency saw the Green Bay Packers ink up running back Josh Jacobs and safety Xavier McKinney. They also re-signed some of their own, Keyshawn Nixon, Corey Ballantyne, and Tyler Davis. They did have some departures, though. Aaron Jones went to the Vikings. David Bakhtiari, he was released. John Runyon to the Giants. Darnell Savage with the Jacksonville Jaguars. And Jonathan Owens went to the Chicago Bears. For the Wisconsin Sports Zone Network, I'm Ebo.
Welcome in on a Thursday edition of the Bill Michaels Show. Got some rain and Vec. But I'll tell you this. I'm feeling good today. Feeling good today and excited because we are in the throes of conference tournaments. You got college hoops on. Now you got to the Badgers a little bit later on today. As a matter of fact, the Badgers get underway at 1 o'clock. They take on Maryland. You've got Marquette coming up tonight. They take on Villanova. I think that's an 8:30 tip time at Madison Square Gardens. The Bucks tonight, 7 o'clock. So you got Bucks basketball coming up tonight. And so we're in kind of the throes of it. I always love this time of year. And we are in the throes of getting ready for the tournament. Selection Sunday going on, and you know, I love it. Still didn't get any Girl Scout cookies though. I got to get some Girl Scout cookies. I haven't gotten any of that stuff yet.
You gotta up your game.
I know. I haven't. I didn't even leave the house yesterday. Yesterday I could have walked around in my underwear all day, and I didn't do much. I literally got off the air and turned on college basketball and was just, I was watching it during the show yesterday. And I was watching college basketball, and then I sat at the desk and I got on conference calls when I got off the air, probably about 10 after 2. And I think I looked at my phone. It was about 8:30 at night. And I'd been on conference calls the entire time about the show, about the motorcycle ride, the foundation, Fisher House. I just had a whole bunch of stuff. And so, I got busy. And all of a sudden, I look at my watch and I'm like, okay, I need to go eat. I sat down. I had gone to, I told you, I went to, I love that song. God, I love that song. I went to Robert's Specialty Meats the other day and I picked up some chicken breasts and some Italian sausages. And I had those and, made a little food and went to bed. Woke up this morning and I was back on conference calls this morning at 6:30 in the morning. So yeah, it's been locked to the desk. I haven't gone anywhere. Listened to the rain a little bit and that was it. Not a whole lot beyond that. But tonight, I'm really looking forward to tonight. Hopefully I get a chance. I'd love to be able to go down to the bar, down to the Wagon Wheel tonight and sit and eat some dinner and just have games on down there. Have all 5 TVs going, just games on. That would be spectacular. So, let's see here. 877-867-1670, 877-867-1670. If you want to find us, please feel free. Go ahead and give us a shout. Please feel free to go ahead and give us a call. You can also track us down on X. X has us at @Bill_Michaels, @Bill_Michaels, or @WiscoGrant, @WiscoGrant. You can find us on Instagram as well. The Bill Michaels Show. Same thing on Facebook, facebook.com/TheBillMichaelsShow. YouTube, simply go to youtube.com, subscribe, hit the subscribe button, /BillMichaelsShow. youtube.com/BillMichaelsShow. It doesn't cost you a thing. It's free. It's absolutely free. Go watch it on YouTube and you can watch the show, listen to the show, whatever it happens to be. And you can find us on the apps, which are Twitch TV, Kick TV. There's LinkedIn you can find us on if you want to watch over there. I mean, there's so many different places to go. Email the program, thebillmichaels@gmail.com, thebillmichaels@gmail.com. The website, simply thebillmichaels.com, thebillmichaels.com. And then you can find us Spotify, Apple, iTunes, Google Podcasts, all that kind of good stuff as well. So there you go. Mark says, I was watching college basketball last night and one of the analysts on the desk was Tom Crean. What is he doing now? He's not still coaching Georgia, is he? Is he coaching Georgia or is he? Because I know he went to Georgia at one point. I don't think he's coaching anybody right now, is he?
Yeah, I think he's just a free agent. I had to double check. I'm like, I think he was last at Georgia, but no longer.
Yeah. God, I can't believe it's been 21 years since Marquette went to the Final Four. It seems like it was yesterday. 21 years. Holy mackerel. So, hey, can you believe that Cincinnati knocked off Kansas last night? Did you watch that game?
I did not.
Oh, my goodness.
I had some NBA games on, and then I wasn't really paying attention. I didn't even know that happened, to be honest. Yeah,
Cincinnati knocked off Kansas last night in the Big 12 tournament. I mean, it wasn't like they beat them. They beat the hell out of them. They beat them by 20 last night. It was crazy. Cincinnati was out of the tournament. I mean, it was like the second half, they were down, I don't know, what was it, 25 or something like that in the first game, and I can't remember who they played. And they came, they hit like 18 three-pointers in the second half of that ball game. It was, I'd never seen anything like it. It was just this come-from-behind win where you were left shaking your head, and you thought, okay, the magic wears off, and all of a sudden you find now I think they take on Baylor, if I'm not mistaken. I think they take on Baylor. But then they destroyed Kansas. I was just shocked. But then you had Stephen A. Austin last night, big bucket. You had buzzer beaters in some of the smaller tournaments. I mean, it's so exciting. You know, last night they were just flipping back and forth. I was watching on FS1. I was watching on ESPN. And there was another channel. I can't remember what other channel had it, but I was flipping back and forth between games last night. And it was just, I was just a basketball junkie. It was great. It was great. It was great to watch last night. 877-867-1670. Okay, before we get into the Bryce Terang stuff, I want to go back to Steve, who had emailed us. He was talking about the Brewers, and, you know, hopefully they can find somebody to take Devin Williams' place, because if you're just tuning us in, Devin Williams now out 3 months, stress fractures in his spine, in his back. So he is down for the next 3 months, and, you know, hope he comes back. But, man, that's pretty severe. Then he says, the Packers, I think maybe they are done in free agency. But if some names aren't signed in the next few days, would you see them going in for a discounted signing with somebody like a Devin White or an Eric Armstead? Next few days, no. Next few weeks, maybe. But I think they're done with the bigger spending. I think now it would be let the chips fall where they may, and whatever's left, maybe we'll bring it in. Also, don't forget there's June 1st cutdown days. They can still be players there because they still have money to spend. So I think they're kind of set. They may bring somebody back. You never know, but I think they're kind of set. It wouldn't shock me, but from all the speculation about the Packers that I hear anyway, is that they're not going to spend any more big money. They like to have that cushion of about $15 million during the season so they can make some moves if they have to. He says, the Bucks, huge game tonight in question, which Bucks team is going to show up. I know the West Coast trip took a lot out of them, but they need to bounce back, and the Bucks really need to play some defense over the next few games. Bucky and Marquette, I think both teams win round one, but Bucky's Big Ten tournament may end in round two. Marquette can go deeper, but doubtful if they can't do it without Kolick. Have a great Thursday. That's our buddy Steven Richfield. Yeah, Tyler Kolick, kind of the straw that stirs the drink for Marquette. He is not going to be playing in that game this evening. I would hold him out. Me personally, I would hold him out because you already know what you are, and he's got the oblique strain, and you don't mess with those things. If it's not 100%, and I mean really 100%, you don't mess with it. So it's a tough break because it may affect your seating a little bit. But because there's really no good time for an injury, but you really want to take it easy, because the worst thing you would want to do is bring him back in the Big East tournament a little too soon, and he tweaks it a little, and then all of a sudden you're looking at whether or not he can play or can't play, or if he's even effective when they go to the NCAA tournament. So if you can hang on to him till next Thursday or Friday, I don't think I'd play him at all. 877-867-1670. If you want to chime in, feel free to go ahead and do so. Okay, now, you've got yesterday, the Brewers second baseman, Bryce Terang. First of all, he was asked in the offseason, hey, look, did you go out and did you, because his offense, defensively, stellar. Offensively, not nearly as good. Did he go out and work with a specific hitting coach and do a lot of hitting in the offseason?
Yeah, I worked extremely hard. Definitely did some talking with my dad, and worked hard to just kind of get back to the ways of, you know, line drives back up the middle, you know, putting myself in the best situation to do that, and just being super direct to the ball, just straight to the ball. So it's been good. I mean, I feel really good up there, and just going up there and competing every day.
Then he was asked, like, look, you know, so you talk about, you know, driving the ball up the middle more, concentrating on just the swing, So the way he's been hitting in spring training, he's been able to put bat to ball and drive the ball a little bit. And the question is, do you think that you could be a little bit more of even a power hitter this season?
I think more so just like scoring the ball up, you know, controlling what I can control and hitting the ball hard back up the middle and allowing things to just happen. If I catch it a little bit more out in front, I hit a homer. You know, I'm not going to be trying to do stuff like that. Just trying to have good quality at bats, hit the ball back up the middle hard and let everything else play out.
And then last but not least, you know, second year in the league, obviously. And he was asked, you know, hey, you know, you feel like you've kind of squared some things up and got some things right in the offseason with your stroke. Defensively, you're stellar. We all know that. So do you feel like as a second year ball player in the majors, are you feeling a lot more confident right now?
No, yeah, for sure. I mean, you definitely, I wouldn't say comfortable, but you understand. You get it. You get how the thing, like how to go along with things. And these guys here helped a ton with making you feel comfortable.
So there you go. And he feels good. I mean, you know, doesn't sound overly enthusiastic, but certainly has a lot of confidence when it comes to that. So hopefully Bryce Terang can give you some offense this year that's better than what he did last year. And if that, you know, then even makes his defense confidence-wise even better. Holy mackerel. I'll tell you this. The up-the-gut battery, your main battery up the gut in for the Brewers this season, defensively speaking, you know, and we can talk about the offense all we want, but, you know, defensively speaking, with Bryce Terang at second, still Willy Adames at short, you've got guys you can rotate out in center field and a ton of speed. And then the way Contreras played last year coming into this season, holy mackerel. You're really defensively set. Now, how much that translates into, you know, taking away runs, we'll have to wait and see. But you got to think it's going to have that kind of an impact, right? And if you can take away a run every few games, win a couple of games because of the defense, more so than just powering the ball out of the ballpark for the offense, then it bodes well for the Brewers. And they're going to need it. We all know that. They're going to need it. We'll hear from Greg Gard when we come back because, like I said, the Badgers taking on Maryland today. That's a 1 o'clock tip time. So we'll keep you up to date in the last hour of the program today about all of that as well. This portion of the program brought to you by our friends at Roberts Specialty Meats out in Waukesha. And I had told you about that, that I did a little grilling yesterday. And, God, I just love it. Just enjoy it. Had some of the chicken tenders that I made from the chicken breasts and had an Italian sausage and just had that last night, kind of this little smorgasbord feast. And it was awesome. It was just awesome. Big salad with it, and I was good to go, man. And that's Robert's Specialty Meats. And whether it's, say, a catered event, like maybe whether it's a wedding or something, and you want meat at the wedding, or by chance you want to do something like, say, the midterm at a golf outing or something, they can do that as well. And they've got a meat salad. They've got different deli items, cheeses and such. But if you just want to go down there and get steaks or something grillable, like the ribs on a stick, which is really easy if you want to do a tailgate, the garlic parm chicken skewers, or the different styles of sausages that they hand make right there, you cannot go wrong. That's Robert's Specialty Meats in Waukesha. Go to robertsspecialtymeatswaukesha.com, robertsspecialtymeatswaukesha.com, or just check them out, Sunset Drive in Waukesha. You will not be disappointed.
Ready. This is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Bill Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Waterfront Sports Bar and Grill. Got the name Sports right in it. So if you are in the Lake Country area, Pewaukee area, Delafield area, I can go through the whole list. But if you're around that area, you know where you're at. On the Lakeview Boulevard in Pewaukee, they're going to have all the games on. So if you're looking for a place to go hunker down and get some good food and just chill and take it easy, that's a great place. Plus, I had said that they just had the Pewaukee girls high school basketball team that won state. They had threw a big pizza party for them. They're always doing something charitable wise, whether it's a meat raffle or some kind of a fundraiser. They did it for the food pantry. There was a local family that was in need. They were helping out. They always do something good. So if you want to support a good business that supports the community, that's our friends at Curly's Waterfront Sports Bar and Grill on Pewaukee Lake, right there on Lakeview Boulevard in Pewaukee. So stop in, tell them we said hi, because Ryan and his staff are great people. I haven't eaten out there in a while. I got to get back out that direction. So Greg Gard, you've got to the Badgers getting ready to take on Maryland and the Terrapins. And so that being said, Greg Gard was asked a couple of different things. First of all, he was asked about, you know, hey, are you confident that your team is going to make the cut for the NCAA tournament for kind of, you know, how you stumbled a little bit down the stretch?
Again, you go back to November, December, January, you sputter a little bit in February. We've got a really good resume. You know, I'm not going to get it onto the quad ones, quads twos, and who's played who and who has the most quad one wins and all that. We're right there. So we'll worry about that in another week and a half.
He was also asked, he said, okay, look, if you were on the committee, do you feel that the team this year that, you know, the way you perform beginning and end and all that kind of stuff, do you feel that you're worthy of an NCAA tournament bid?
I don't even really get into that. I mean, our body of work speaks for itself. You look at who we played and what we've did throughout the course of the year. Yeah.
Going 3-8 since February 1st, you know, it's not a good look. And we all know that. We, you know, saw the way they played against Rutgers, and I'll tell you this though, they fought hard against Purdue in that final game. They really did. And they played better maybe than I expected. So You had a couple of losses, obviously, that you wish you had back, but 3-8 since September 1st. And the question then is, how have the players inside that locker room, how have those guys responded?
They haven't flinched and felt sorry for themselves. They understand, you know, this is part of it, part of the journey. And you know, continue to get yourself out of the, you know, predicament you're in, and you know, continue to get better. And the next 40 minutes is what we need to focus on. And they did a good job of preparing for that.
So there you go. Get ready for Maryland. Got a 1 o'clock tip time today, 1 o'clock ish tip time today. And hopefully the Badgers can get themselves a win. Actually, I think it's, correct me if I'm wrong, it's like 1:30 central time is what about the time that they're about going to get underway. Said 1 o'clock, but I think it's 1:30 ish. So, so anyway, they take on being the 5 seed facing the 12 seed that is Maryland, and they have them today. So good luck to the Badgers. Good luck to Marquette too. I mean, big story there is Tyler Kolick is out with an oblique strain and is not going to, you know, play today. To me, if I'm Marquette, you get a couple of wins in a tournament, and without Kolick, you're fine. Just, you're not going to fall that dramatically, if at all, because you know that Tyler Kolick is coming back, and they're going to, the committee usually understands that. So they'll know that. So hopefully Marquette still draws a really good seed in the tournament, and they're able to get a couple of wins in the Big East tournament at Madison Square Garden, and then, you know, find themselves still a 2 or a 3 seed, maybe at worst, in the tournament. And then off they go. You get Tyler Kolick back, knock on wood. Hopefully he does. And that oblique strain doesn't bother him the rest of the way. So cross your fingers there. 877-867-1670. Going back to the Brewers stuff, Michael says, this appears to be all on the Brewers medical staff. He had issues last year with his back, if you remember, and the staff cleared him. He did miss some time with a sore back last season. This is the same medical staff that said Woodruff would be back by June 1st last year. You can look that up as well. It's really too bad. This could be a little karma coming back to him from the, quote, drunken, broken hand injury just before the playoffs a few years ago. And that's from Mike. Mike, the karma for that was that he broke his hand before the postseason. That's karma. That you throw the punch, and that does, you know, what it did to the bone in your hand, and he couldn't participate then when they needed him. But this, you could be right. You could be right. I mean, you know, I always marvel at medical staffs, you know, because there's trainers who are, they're all trained. They're all very well trained. And some people that have the analytic capabilities, others don't, or at least not as in depth. And then, you know, when you have something like this that flares up, you go to see a specialist. So I don't know if it was what happened to him last year. I do know this, though. Down the stretch, he didn't have problems. And had it been stress fractures back then that were misdiagnosed, don't you think they would have shown up at the end of the season last year when he was pitching? Because he pitched pretty well down the stretch. That I do remember as well. So I'm not going to go after the medical staff, because I just don't know if the two are related. We just don't know. But my assumption would have been he's only a couple of weeks into spring training, right? Middle of February. So he's been a month, 4 weeks into spring training. So I'm kind of thinking to myself, if it was something that was related to what last year had, it would have shown up last year at the end of the season, because he rested, came back, and was fine, seemingly fine after that. Didn't have the same issues. So, or maybe it was the beginning, but you really couldn't tell. There was no way to tell. Maybe it was the beginning. I don't know. But regardless, I agree with you. It's a shame. I don't think it's karma, but it's a shame. 100%. Our buddy Kevin says, hey, it's a sign as to how much the players are playing at a young age as the body begins to develop. Could it be that, like AAU baseball and year-round sports, or so many coaches only want to concentrate on one sport, so many young players with back and arm issues and getting hurt, seeing so many issues not only in baseball but in all sports right now? And that's from our friend Kevin. Kristen's son, you know, his dad has him in everything. I mean, even after games, they're practicing before games and going to extra hitting and going to extra cages. And he's 12 years old, 13 years old, and he's got something going on in his shoulder, which affected his elbow, and he can't play. I don't know. It's could be overuse. You know, you hear a lot of doctors tell you about kids' growth plates and, how much you play when you're a kid, and you just, the body just hasn't become equipped to handling that. And the more you stretch out ligaments and the more you stretch out joints at that young age, and things begin, as the joints pop back constantly, you begin to build up scar tissue at a young age. I mean, they're seeing more and more of that. I got a buddy of mine whose son, he refused to allow his son to play on these big travel teams and all that stuff because he said, I didn't want to hurt my kid. And then finally, when he got to high school, he excelled. He really excelled. And some of the kids that have been playing the AAU stuff continuously in these travel teams and these travel leagues, they were all breaking down. They really haven't gotten a ton better either. They don't get a chance to recover. One of the biggest things they will tell you, and I hate to get off of my soapbox here, but if you're a parent and you got your kid doing everything, one of the biggest things they will tell you, and I know everybody kind of rolls their eyes at doctors. It's kind of like brush twice a day, brush away from the gums, whatever. Okay. You know, eat your vegetables, apple a day, whatever. But there is something to be said for the body and recovery. And even when you get older, one of the biggest things when it comes to dieting, it's that any dietitian and any doctor will tell you, you know, it's caloric intake and exercise output. We understand all of that. Okay. And there's plenty of ways to kind of get around that with today's medicine. However, the number one thing they will tell you is rest. You got to get rest. You got to give the body a day off. If you're dragging and, you know, you're one of those people like, I'm so tired, but I'm going to go to the gym. You got to rest. It's amazing what the body will do when it gets rest and how it heals itself. That's what it's meant to do. It's made to do that. So I don't know. I hate to get off on the tangent, but I don't know. I couldn't honestly tell you, you know, it is what it is. 877-867-1670 coming up here at the bottom of the hour. Our guy, Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show. We're going to talk with him about the Devin Williams injury and about his thoughts on who the closer might be for the Milwaukee Brewers, or how they might kind of morph this thing into the closer by committee, so to speak. But regardless, hey, talking Brewers, always a good thing. Don't forget, coming up, we're less than 3 weeks away now. Tuesday, April 2nd, the Brewers home opener. We are going to be live. We're going to be at Stenny, second and National in Walker's Point. Cannot wait for this. Our traditional every year, we open it up down at Stenny's for the last 4 or 5 years, and it's been great. We have so much fun. But this year, the game doesn't start at 1:30. The game starts at 3:20, I think, or 3:15-ish, which means you can almost spend the entire time down there with us. You can hang out and come out for the show, catch the shuttle over to American Family Field, let them do the driving, go in, catch the game, mill around the parking lot, catch the shuttle back, and it's a great day. You don't have to drive. You can have some fun, have a few beverages early. It's awesome. Plus, you catch hopefully some good Brewer baseball at home. And what, you know, what's better than opening day? Right? Opening day in the baseball season at home. It's fantastic. We're going to be at Stenny's, second and National, Walker's Point, having a great time doing the show, getting ready for the Brewers opening day on Tuesday, April 2nd. We hope to see you there as a face in the crowd. Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show, coming up next.
This is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Hey, so have you tried fried chicken from Quick Trip? Ooh, freshly cooked, hot, and ready. And I'm talking jumbo, hand-breaded chicken tenders, boneless wings dripping with all your favorite sauces. Or how about 8 pieces of fried chicken deliciousness? Perfect for your next large group meal. I mean, this is fried chicken that slays. I'm not talking about the runway. Slays appetites, fills you up. This is no ordinary chicken. It'll make any meal extraordinary. Quick Trip, fried chicken, ready for your next meal. See you next time.
0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote. We take the time to listen and educate you on all your product options. And with DesignWorks, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Whether you're looking to replace your windows due to damage, or it's time for a refresh and you'd like to revitalize your home style, choosing from Pella's wide range of windows and doors will complement your home's unique design. Pelican also customized, providing nearly endless possibilities for maximum design flexibility with dramatic sizes, custom colors, finishes, profiles, product types, and more. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Bill Michaels will resume in 5 minutes. Michaels will resume in 4 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Bill Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Michael's show on this kind of rainy day where you count your blessings and say, hey, it's not snow. A little bit of rain, always good for the grass growing, it's getting green. Got the roof open down at American Family Field. Just wish we had better news than Devin Williams being down for 3 months. Joining us now on the hotline, our guy Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show on 97.3 The Game in Milwaukee. Tim, how you doing, buddy?
Well, yeah, I'm standing outside in my slippers, and unfortunately, it's rain coming down. You're right. It's not snow. What do they say? March and April showers in Wisconsin brings mud until June. So we got that to look forward to. So I'm standing outside, and of course, walk the dog. You know what that's like.
Right.
Walk the dog, sluice right into the biggest puddle you can find. And so now my feet are cold, and well, we'll warm you up with some Brewers conversation.
So let's start with Devin Williams, and it's not the kind of conversation we wanted to talk about, Tim, but he goes down with stress fractures in his back, and that's never a good thing. And I knew the minute they said they're going to see a specialist, it wasn't going to be good news, and sure enough, we got some of the worst possible. So give me your thoughts on the back end of the bullpen now.
Well, yeah, we're seeing it more and more, Bill, that, you know, immediately last night on social media, and I know you saw it too, that a little bit of controversy there. And it's like, well, Brewers said that, you know, it was nothing major, and then he wanted a second opinion. I think we've learned a few things over the years. I think both professionally and in the sports world that it's okay to get this is why you get second opinions. It's not the scoff. It's not the, you know, really knock anybody's specialist, but a second opinion is okay in the medical world, not only professionally in that sports world, but I think in our personal lives too. It's okay to get the second opinion. You want that. You see other sides of the story. So we wanted to, you know, I would like to put that to rest. And I don't look at it as controversial. I just look at it as, you know, it's, hey, he's a human being. He wants another opinion. He's entitled to that right. So what does it mean for the Brewers? Well, it's not like Freddy Peralta, Wade Miley. The news seems to be getting better and better. You didn't lose a workhorse like Colin Ray. You lost a guy that is wicked. Don't get me wrong. One of the best, if not the best, in baseball. 36 saves, 1.5 ERA. But it is a department of strength for this baseball team. So to find that sort of silver lining here, Bill, I think is one thing to key on. Now, who's going to close? Well, they're out getters, as counsel taught us years ago. One of the younger guys, is it Uribe? You got a control issue there, throws hard, nasty stuff. Is it McGill? Throws hard, nasty stuff. But again, control might be a little bit of an issue. My guess is they're going to go with Pyomps. I think it's a safe play there. And I think he can get on a roll and kind of capture that closing spot.
That's what I hinted to a little bit earlier. Now, here's the other question. And you know that the arm that everybody's talking about down in the minors is Mizorowski. And, you know, it would be great if they could bring him up at some point and he really becomes that guy, because Uribe can throw hard, but he doesn't throw for strikeouts on the continuum. If Mizorowski could come up and maybe make a little hay in the back end of that bullpen, that wouldn't be a bad way to go. But you don't put a rookie in a closing situation automatically. You know what I mean?
You know, you're right. And they're going to bring him along a little bit on the, you know, maybe predictable side. And that is kind of ease him in. Look what they did with Burns and Woodruff. You know, they worked those guys in right around what 17, 18 range. And that seemed to be sort of the cardinal way of things. They would always start their starters out in that bullpen, get their feet wet a little bit, learn how to travel, learn the Major League Baseball protocols, and it relaxed them more, and they turned into great starters, as we know. So that, I think that's what they're going to do with Mizorowski. But, you know, there's another guy in camp there, Brian Hudson, who is a big, tall one. I think the tallest in Brewers history, I want to say, or at least tied with maybe a Cameron Lowe or a Richie Sexton or someone. But he's a guy that's got nasty stuff. And so you might find this bright little surprise. And then when Devin does ultimately come back, you may have found another guy that you say, hey, yeah, we got surprised with a negative, but look at this. Look, it created a surprise on the positive. So that end of the story here, Bill, is that bullpen, it's got some they were the second best bullpen in all of baseball last mm-hmm. year.
Right.
I mean, they've got some nastiness out in that bullpen. And I don't, you know, are they going to regress just a little bit? Maybe. But they're not going to hit the floor. There's too much talent out there.
Right. Give me your thoughts on Bryce Durang. Seemed very optimistic. He no more than gets dubbed the starter, goes out and goes 3-for-3. Looks as if he's got a little bit better poke so far this spring training. Give me your thoughts on Bryce Durang and maybe if what he can give you at the plate.
Came in a little bit more beefed up, a little bit muscled up. You got to do better in 218 with your batting average, and he's on a quest to do a little bit better than that. And I think he has earned, Bill, and he's outstanding with the glove. We all know that. Gold glove caliber guy. So we don't have to worry about that. But, you know, he's got to hit for a better average, a better on base. He just does. And so I think he's earned the start. And Murph said the other day that, hey, he's our second baseman. Now, you do have the backup plan. You've got a Monasterio out there. You've got, if you need, a Vinny Capra at this point, Arroyo. So you've got some moving parts there to cover it. But you've invested this much time. Give him the go here early on. Give him half a season. Let's see what he can do, and maybe he'll surprise us.
Thoughts on Rhys Hoskins, because I look at Rhys Hoskins, William Contreras, also Christian Yelich. Those are your pop guys. Those are your elder statesmen, so to speak, guys looking to either come back from an injury or extend what they did last season. On one hand, I look at it and go, hold your breath. On the other hand, I'm kind of excited about this. I'm excited to see what Christian Yelich, a little bit more bulked up Christian Yelich, can do. He had a little more poke so far in spring training. Hoskins is certainly looking the way he's supposed to look and maybe what he can return to from a couple of years ago. Give me your thoughts on the veterans there.
Yeah, no, and you know, the one that we don't talk about, he's still there. Hello, people. There's Willie Adames here.
Yep.
I mean, everybody's talking about Hoskins and Contreras, and rightly so. No question. Contreras, my goodness, they have found a good one. And I think we're just scratching the surface for what this kid is. And he's still young, Bill. It's amazing. So you get some certainty at first base with Hoskins. Now, again, this is, you know, really stating that, you know, the injury is going to be behind him. So if he, as you said, if he comes back to what he was, at least you got some steadiness there. Mm-hmm. You don't have to flip flop around and have 68,000 first basemen since Prince Fielder left.
Right.
But yeah, now on the other side, you have the younger guys. So here's what needs to happen for this offense to be, you know, 11th in the league or something like that, you know, upper third. They have to have two other young guys splash. They just do. And if they don't, then this offense, the muscle guys you just talked about, can only do so much. They need Churio, Mitchell, Frelick, and maybe a Weimer, maybe another guy that comes up, a Tyler Black. They need two of those guys to splash. Like, oh, man, look at this. And that being said, apparently, Murph thinks it's Sal Frelick. And because they think so highly of Churio and Mitchell, there's not enough room out there. Yelich isn't coming out of left field. So you have to find a place for one of those. The DH, maybe a Sanchez. You know, you're going to have some moving parts there. But they, like Murph said the other day, we have not put enough emphasis on Sal Frelick at third. And quote, it'll be one of the best stories in all of baseball is the Sal Frelick move to third base. So two of those guys got a splash and they've got to hit. And you get those high round draft choices. There's enough talent there that, you know, you can't catch and hear of these guys. You got to hit on some of these guys,
right.
And hopefully it's two of them.
Well, that's my next question, because you mentioned Willy Adames. First of all, he gave you the power numbers last year, but he's got to get a better, you know, batting average. You and I are still old school in believing that a batting average absolutely matters in some way, shape, or form. So he's got to give you a better batting average. And last year, the batting average and the struggles at the plate, even though he gave you power numbers, seemed to affect him in the field a little bit too. So that's another guy that if he gives you a little more splash, a little more pop, or even you know, a better on-base percentage, I think also he's a guy that can really kind of help you out as well. And you're right. We don't talk about him enough, man.
No, and you know what? For those that believe in walk years, contract years, call them what you want, it's where Willie is. And Willie is, you know, is he going to bet on himself? Are the Brewers going to say, hey, we'll offer you an extension? And then even that's a, you know, offensively speaking, that's a risk, because if you don't get that batting average up, that means your on base is going to stay at 300 to 90 something. And that's just unacceptable. And he knows that. I was watching the game the other night and he's swinging at low and outside stuff. And it's like, Willie, you got to take your walks, man. You got to make them pitch to you. And so hopefully that'll happen, but he's got to bring the batting. I'm with you, man. You and I have been in lockstep for well over a decade here. A batting average at least means you're getting on base through hitting, and then you're going to take your walks, which then in lies your raised on base percentage. So it all emanates from there. I'm not opposed to OPS. I mean, OPS is a great stat too, but it starts with getting on base, and starting with getting on base, you can't walk every time. So you got to hit your way on and get yourself an average. So looking forward to it.
Real quick before I let you go, we mentioned Sal Frelick in the third base position. Do you think Sal Frelick is the opening day starter at third?
It's funny. They just announced a Jose Quintana will start 2 weeks from today. Oh, there's a shocker, David Stearns, right?
Yeah, right.
The Brewer killer. I mean, it is absolute lights out against the Brewers throughout his career. They've gotten to him a couple of times, but they avoided him last year early in the season because he was hurt. But yeah, I find it hard to believe that Frelick would be an everyday third baseman. Maybe I'm wrong based on what Murph says. It sounds like he's going to be. But I don't know. I think Monasterio has a lot to say in there too.
Yeah.
And I think Murph, you don't think he'll play mix and match?
Oh, absolutely.
Council learned things from Murph. Murph inevitably had to have learned some things from Council too. So I think mix and match isn't quite all the way dead. And I hope I'm proved wrong. I like the hot guys to stay in there. And you just play him out regardless of matchup. But we'll see. I don't know the answer to that. But again, just to summarize, if you go by Murphy, sounds like Frelick is every day.
Tim, you the man, and we're only a couple of weeks away from what you and I like to refer to as a sporting Christmas. So we will enjoy it. I appreciate it, pal.
Can't wait, Bill. We'll talk again.
Thanks, bud. Talk to you later. There you go. That's Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show, 97.3 The Game in Milwaukee, and has been doing it a long, long time, getting his perspective on all of that. So good to talk to him. Really good to kind of catch up a little bit. We haven't done it in a while. This portion of the program brought to you by our friends at Big Boar Barbecue. They are located in West Salem if you're in the La Crosse area. And I'll tell you this. If you don't have Thin Mints, and I don't have Thin Mints yet, I'm waiting for my Girl Scout cookies, but if you're going to sit down and you're going to watch some tournament basketball, get some takeout. Get some takeout. Get some ribs. Get some pulled pork. Get barbecue chicken, whatever it happens to be. Get some of that. Get a big old tub of that macaroni and cheese, some of that coleslaw. Sit back and just comfort food and hoops. That's what's coming up. Comfort food and hoops. Give them a call, 608-612 0387. Order ahead, 608-612-0387, or just simply go to BigBoarBBQ.com. BigBoarBBQ.com for a lunch, a dinner. Let them cater. Throw a big old party. Have some of your, you know, your customers in or something to that effect. Go someplace and watch the games. But Big Boar Barbecue, they can help you out in many different facets. And like I said, family owned and they cater. So again, call them 608-612-0387 or go to BigBoarBBQ.com.
Covering Wisconsin sports like a blanket, this is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Make it a real Mad March with a playoff payout at Pottawatomie. Every week, you could score your share of 100 grand in cash and free play. Play this March for drawing entries. Win each Thursday. Plus, the prizes refresh every week for even more winners. The playoff payout at Pottawatomie, Milwaukee. It's anyone's game. For more details, visit paysbig.com/payout. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes. Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Welcome back. Bill Michaels Show, we continue on, man, that fast. 2 hours have come and gone. I'll get you some updates here. As we've got a lot of hoop scores, which is just awesome. A lot of hoop scores coming up. We'll get you caught up on some of the tournaments that are going on. Aaron Rodgers, by the way, making news today, saying, as I am on the record saying in the past, what happened in Sandy Hook was an absolute tragedy. I am not and have never been of the opinion that the events did not take place. Again, I hope that we learn from this and other tragedies to identify the signs that will allow us to prevent unnecessary loss of life. My thoughts and prayers continue to remain with the families affected, along with the entire Sandy Hook community. There was there was a lot of conjecture, and this whole thing about him becoming a vice president, running mate, and all that kind of stuff brought up a lot of things that he is kind of alluded to or gotten involved with. And he's very much of the conspiracy minded, you know, type of stuff. And I don't know why this all of a sudden became a thing, but suddenly he was thrown into the mix that there are people that believe Sandy Hook never happened, which is the most ridiculous thing. But some people have their beliefs. I don't know why, but, you know, okay. So he got lumped into this. And apparently, you know, at least in New York, there were some people that were saying things either on the air or phone calls or something that started to accuse him of being part of this and a part of this belief that certain things didn't happen. And it's like, no, you know, look, here's the thing with conspiracies. And you got to remember this. Think about this for a minute, okay? If you have 50 people in your office, you all work for the same company, okay? And out of, say, 5,000, you're a big company, and you got 50 people in your office. Do you think 50 people in your office are going to keep a zip, lip-tight secret and take it to the grave? Or do you think somebody's going to say something and leak it out, right? So when it comes to conspiracies, something of these types of magnitude, you have to rely on so many people. That's why when they say that NBA and such is fixed, there's not a concentrated effort to fix it. Is there some biases? Yeah, there can be. But no, the stuff isn't fixed. You know, what Tim Donaghy was doing, the NBA referee, was trying to fix some games, or at least not necessarily say who won or lost, but fix games for those that were betting on them. But no, it's a huge, and even then he got caught. Even then. So it's, you know, I understand, but no. So he had to, I guess, come out with an apology or at least a statement saying he doesn't, never said that. So there you go. Anyway, craziness. We got 2 more hours yet to go. That was a fast 2 hours. Holy mackerel. More of the Bill Michaels Show coming up right after this.
This is a Wisconsin Sports Zone update.
Well, it's game day for the Badgers. They're in Minneapolis to play in the second round of the Big Ten tournament against Maryland. Terrapins took out Rutgers last night to advance. Wisconsin and Maryland played earlier this year in Madison with the Badgers coming out on top. Tip is coming up around at 1:30. The winner gets Northwestern in tomorrow's quarterfinals. Tourney, the Bucks, they are also back in action tonight as the 76ers come to Fiserv Forum. Milwaukee coming back from a 1-3 road trip out west that saw them get blown out by 35 points in 2 of those losses. Coach Doc Rivers blamed their offense for the losses despite what they allowed defensively. Milwaukee comes into the game tied for second in the East with Cleveland and 9.5 games back of first place Boston. Tip is at 7. Meanwhile, Brewers got some bad news last night. ESPN reporting that closer Devin Williams going to miss 3 months with 2 stress fractures in his back. Reigning NL reliever of the year pitched with soreness last September, and it came back this spring. Pitched just twice this spring, allowing 4 runs in 1 3rd innings. Joel Piamps and Abner Uribe could serve as Milwaukee's closer while Williams goes through rehab.
Rural Mutual Insurance, keeping Wisconsin strong.
As a proud sponsor of the WIAA, Rural Mutual roots for all of Wisconsin's student athletes. Whether they're a hometown hero or they dream of the national spotlight, sportsmanship keeps Wisconsin strong. Visit ruralmutual.com/WIAA to learn more about how they support high school athletics.
Rural Mutual Insurance, keeping Wisconsin strong.
Well, Wisconsin will hold its pro day tomorrow in Madison. Braylon Allen and Tanner Mordecai among the players slated to work out for NFL scouts. Allen expected to run the 40-yard dash after not doing so at the NFL Combine. Meanwhile, Packers made the release of linebacker Devondre Campbell official yesterday. He got off to a great start in Green Bay, all pro back in 2021, but his production fell off the last 2 years. With this Wisconsin Sports Zone Network update, I'm Zach Heilprin.
Welcome back. Good to have you. Bill Michaels Show. Fun day today. Fun day today. You've got, let's see here. You've got basketball being played. UConn, the number one team in the country, taking on Xavier right now at the half, and they are only up a point in the Big East tournament. The ACC, you've got Carolina easily handling Florida State, who got the win yesterday, 46-30 right now. That game also at the half. What else do we have for you? Some scores that are in progress. You got some of the smaller conferences going on. By the way, Minnesota right now beating Michigan State. That's at the half by two, 34-32 in that one. And trying to look at some of the other tournaments that are going on as we speak. Texas Tech 27-14 over BYU right now. And that's kind of it. You got Kent State beating Toledo 59-55 in that contest. Like we said, coming up a little bit later on today, you got the Badgers, 1 o'clock taking on Maryland, 8:30 tonight. You got Marquette and Villanova, 7 o'clock tonight. You got some pro basketball. You got the Bucks back at the Fiserv Forum. They're taking on the Philadelphia 76ers. So there you go. That's a lot of what's happening. So hopefully you're pretty caught up. And if you've got something of interest, well, then you have to track it down. But we do the best we can. So there you go. Let's go to the phone calls. Let's open it up for some phones coming up in this hour. Also, we're going to talk with Zach Heilprin. And we'll get his take on the Badgers as they now take on Maryland and get ready to talk to him regarding the Big Ten tournament. And a great guard's comments left over from yesterday. Let's go to Scott listening to us on the South Side. Scott, welcome to the program, man. What's happening?
Not much, Bill. This is like my third time talking to you.
Okay. Good to have you back.
Thanks to Grant, of course, a bud of mine. Being a Colorado fan, Broncos fan, of course, do you think that they're going to be trying to wait for something for Justin Fields and the Bears to try to trade for him? Or are they going to draft somebody like Bo Nix, for instance?
That's a great question. Well, first of all, the answer is to both. I mean, if they're going to get a quarterback and they're going to see, maybe they're going to try to develop Justin Fields. I mean, I don't know what the market is for Justin Fields right now. And the longer you wait, the more the price comes down. So yes, if they're going to make a move, you're going to wait a while. But my whole thing right now would be, what do they got? Jared, is it Stidham would be their quarterback right now?
Yeah, Stidham would be their only option at the moment.
Yeah. So you got to think that they're going to pick up a quarterback in the draft. That's got to be their goal. Yeah, you got to pick up a quarterback in the draft. As to who and who they have their eyes on, here's the other question. How much do you go in? You just got burned, right? You just got burned going all in and giving up the world for Russell Wilson. So you just got burned.
Yeah, Patton kind of screwed that
right.
up big time.
So what are you going to do if you're going to go all in on a quarterback? Now, if you believe you've got a generational guy and you're going to draft him, and therefore you're going to have that quarterback in at a bargain basement price for the next 4 years, what are you going to give up to go get him? If you believe that's the guy. But it wouldn't be terrible if you brought in a guy like Justin Fields, who's got a little athleticism and has some running ability, and can win a few ball games, but in the meantime, you've got that ability to draft a quarterback and at least, at the very least, let him sit for a year or half a season or whatever it may be, and that way he can just kind of watch and develop under Sean Payton. But I'll tell you this. I am stunned that Sean Payton wanted nothing to do with Russell Wilson. Aren't you? I mean, it's not like he even thought, well, I'll make him into a good quarterback. It was, I don't want anything to do with this guy, and we'll pay you whatever it takes to get rid of him.
It doesn't surprise me because he wasn't no Drew Brees.
Right. Well, not only was he not Drew Brees, but he was a lot more selfish than Drew Brees ever was.
Yeah, it doesn't surprise me. I think the cheaper the cheaper bet for the Broncos would be to draft on that rookie salary. It'd be cheaper being at their going to be strapped for cash.
Yeah. And here's the other thing is that if the Bears decide to hang on to Justin Fields, and let's just say they do draft Caleb Williams and they take him into the season, there is going to be a team that's going to have a quarterback go down or be in desperate need of a quarterback, and maybe that begins to drive the price back up a little bit. Although I don't think it's going to go up too much, but I think they lost when the quarterback carousel really began to swing with a lot of the signing of the free agents. I think they lost a lot of leverage. And quite frankly, I think there's not as much interest in Justin Fields as a lot of people thought there would be. I think everybody has kind of seen the tape on him. They know what he is. They know he's not an impressively brilliant quarterback. He's an athlete who can throw a football. And so that's kind of what you're going to get, and you're not going to pay a ton for them.
Right. Okay. Well, like I said, I always trust your opinion, and I appreciate it.
Appreciate it, man. Talk to you soon. Yeah, my opinion on a couple of things hasn't been great, but I'll give it to you. That's for sure. But I just – there's a couple of places that maybe Justin Fields could go. It wouldn't be terrible for him to go to a team that has a quarterback and be a backup, be a legitimate backup. And maybe he can sit and learn, little humble pie, maybe go from there. But he's, you know who he would work with a guy, he would work with good in a couple of organizations. He would work good with Harbaugh. Harbaugh's just got a way of making the most out of a quarterback. He would work good with a guy like Shanahan, who can help him learn, who's smarter than your average bear. McVay would be another one that he could work with and maybe become a good quarterback. Knowledgeable wise, who else, Grant? Who else would you say would fit in good with? Would you think?
Well, here's the issue with Russell Wilson is he's always been more of a freelancer, right?
Right.
He's never like Drew Brees stuck to the script with Sean Payton, right. And they attacked the middle of the field. Russell Wilson is not a guy that sticks to the script.
No, nope.
And he had Nathaniel Hackett and kind of got to run the offense his own way, and it was a catastrophe. And then he got Sean Payton, and I assume they wanted to stick to a better script, and that was also not great. So I don't really know. I think Pittsburgh is about as good of an opportunity as he'll have, which is funny because now he's back to the same situation he wanted to get out of in Seattle. Defensive-minded head coach, run the ball, play defense.
Right.
Right. We've gone full circle now with Russell Wilson.
Yeah, exactly. And I think this is, first of all, this is Russell Wilson's last opportunity. I mean, if he plays garbage this year, there's no way they're going to pay him any kind of a large contract going into next season. He would then have to become a glorified backup somewhere or huge, huge, huge amount of humble pie to say, okay, I'm just not worth it anymore. So for Russell Wilson, this is his opportunity. For Justin Fields, I'm trying to think of teams that he could go to where he could actually maybe excel if he had a chance or if he had the right coach around him, so to speak. Like I said, I could see him, you know, I could see him going to Denver. But he also likes to play off script. He's very much a quick tuck and run guy. But Harbaugh would be good. Shanahan would be good. McVay would be good. I really don't want to see him where they already have a young quarterback, unless of course it's a highly drafted quarterback coming in. Otherwise it becomes too much. At what point do you go with his skill set over somebody else's skill set? Same thing with like a Mac Jones. Mac Jones needs a particular system for him to go back and flourish in again to become a better quarterback. I would. Did Mac Jones get signed by anybody, by the way?
Mac Jones got traded to. This is he got traded.
He got traded. That's right. Yeah.
It happened and we just forgot about it. Like he doesn't even exist. Yeah. He's in Jacksonville.
Yeah. That's right. He got traded to Jacksonville. So he's backing up Trevor Lawrence down there. So I forgot about that. He got traded. Because I was thinking for a second he was a free agent, and that would be like a good fit also maybe for him to go to a Sean Payton-esque type of guy and start to learn under him or go be a back. Justin Fields could go be a backup, you know, to like a guy like Herbert, to be Justin Herbert's backup and learn under Harbaugh and understand that system. And you know, I mean, Justin Herbert's a hell of a quarterback, don't get me wrong, but if indeed he should go down, especially on turf, you go with just a guy like Justin Herbert. What do they have? Who's their backup out there? Like Max Dugans, something like that.
Oh, the TCU guy.
Yeah.
I think you're right, actually.
Yeah. So, and they picked him up at the back end of the draft, if I'm not mistaken. So that wouldn't be a horrible spot for Justin Fields to end up. But I just don't know what you do with Fields at this point. If you're Chicago, you're kind of just stuck with him. You're just sitting there going, well, what do we do? And I think just right now, you're just kind of stuck with him. And you're not going to get much for him. And that's, I don't want to say that's a shame, because we all kind of knew what he was when he came into the league. I didn't think he was that great of a passer. He was a really good athlete, but that's what he is. Maybe. Now, this was another suggestion, and this is coming to me from Dave, who says, why don't you put him into a system where you can at least wildcat him? Sean Payton was used to doing that when he was in New Orleans. He did that for many years with Taysom Hill. So maybe you go in that regard. You bring him in. He's a wildcat guy. He can run. He can do a lot of different things, but he doesn't necessarily have to be a full-time quarterback. And maybe you become more dynamic offensively that way until you find yourself the quarterback that can actually play quarterback. And maybe he morphs into something more than what he is in Chicago. But I don't know what you do with him, to be quite honest with you. You know, he's not, doesn't have much value. And I know Chicago's kind of left there again with their junk in their hand going, we spent, you know, all this time, all this thought, all this effort on this guy who we really believe was the next guy, which he was. He was the next guy after a failed Mitch Trubisky, who was the guy. They've just had one, he's the next guy, failure after the other. So I don't know what the value in the market would be for Justin Fields at this point. 877-867-1670. If you want to hit us up, please feel free. Mark says, shame as to what happened with Devin Williams. I feel a little bit better after your conversation with Tim Allen. I do believe that they can go closer by committee, but it's going to be incumbent upon the starters to at least get to the sixth inning for this team to have a lot of success. Do you see that happening? Also, who's going to be the X factor in the starting rotation? Mark, appreciate the email. Mark, by the way, is listening to us down in Lake Geneva. The X factor? The X factor could be a guy like Ashby. He could be a guy like Ashby that comes out and starts to throw well. Excuse me. That's a great question. I don't know. Once Ashby, if he makes his way back up, I mean, he could be the guy. Colin Ray could be the guy. DL Hall, if he really anchors the back end of, say, the rotation, if he becomes that guy. But really, I think your X factor is probably the second guy in the rotation. It's probably Wade Miley. Because if Freddie Peralta throws well, and Miley not only eats up innings, but throws well, he doesn't have to have a 2 ERA to be, you know, to be the X factor. I mean, let's just say he gives you a 3.8 ERA, a 3.9 ERA, right? But pitches consistently and can eat up innings. That's huge. That's huge for this team. So maybe it would be Wade Miley. But beyond that, right now, you're looking for, it's like playing a game of Tetris. You're just kind of waiting to all the squares align to where you can say, okay, they're all locked in, you know, before you get to go to the next round. Just waiting for things to kind of lock themselves in. And they really, I would say the first month of the season may not even tell you right away. Offensively, it will. But I don't even think the first month of the season is going to tell you defensively and pitching-wise how it's all going to lock in. Not yet, anyway. Coming up bottom of the hour, we got Zach Heilprin going to be joining us, sports director WOZN in Madison. He's going to talk some Big Ten tourney with us, and we'd be glad to talk a lot about that, because can't wait for Wisconsin and Maryland coming up a little bit later on today. Got that going on tonight. You got Marquette taking to the hardwood. You got the Bucks taking to the hardwood at the Fiserv Forum. A lot of hoops to chat about. This portion of the program brought to you by our friends at Point Brewing. Brewing excellence since 1857. They just had their very successful Bach run up there in Stevens Point. And in addition to that, they have all the summertime brews getting ready to come out. Look for those. Cider Boys as well. The first press I love, but Cider Boys as well. So many good things coming out of Point Brewing. Plus, if you're going to go take the brewery tour, they are wrapping up the construction of the new Welcome Visitor Zone as well. So a lot of good things happening up in Stevens Point, Wisconsin, right here in our own backyard. That is Point Brewing in Stevens Point.
Covering Wisconsin sports like a blanket, this is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes. Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Bill Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Drizzly, dreary day. Need one of those every now and then, you know? But it's a Thursday. We got college hoops on. Excited about that. Good day today. Good stuff. Coming up bottom of the hour, we're going to talk some college hoops. Speaking of that, with the sports director, WOZN in Madison, our flagship station, Zach Heilprin, is going to be here today, so we'll talk with him coming up here in just a little bit. Stay tuned for that. Let's go to Mike listening to us in Whitewater. Mike, how you doing, pal?
Hey, Billy. Good day. Thanks for taking my call, all right?
Yeah, what's going on?
Hey, you got your Thin Mints and gallon of milk ready for this afternoon?
I don't have the Thin Mints yet, but I got the milk. I'm going to have to head to a local grocery store and see if there's a store set up somewhere for the Girl Scout cookies. I didn't get them yet.
Oh, I think they, like you said before, they got them on the weekends at different places.
Yeah, I haven't been able to venture out and really look for it. I ordered like 2 cases of them. I just haven't had anybody bring them to the house yet, or at least let me know that they're in so I can go get them. So I'll find some, though. You better believe it.
Okay, a couple other things. Do you think we go for a tackle or middle linebacker now?
As far as free agency goes or in the draft? Because in the draft, I think you go for both.
Okay, but is there anybody out there for a middle linebacker tackle?
Tackles. There's a couple of tackles that are still out there. The kid, Tyron Smith coming out of the Dallas organization. The problem is that both tackles that are on the market. Both bigger tackles that are on the market have injury issues. They're not able to stay healthy consistently, and that's been part of the problem, and that's probably one of the reasons that they're still sitting out there. As far as linebackers go, I'd probably try to fill the bill via safety again. If I'm going to take another free agent that's sitting out there, I might go in the direction of free agency rather than just taking another one from the draft. I might look at another free agent. There's a couple of free agents that are out there too as well.
What about, you just said about safety, is Micah Hyde still out there? You think he'd come back since we misused him before?
Boy, that's a great question. I don't know. I did not see if he was signed by anybody. I haven't kind of checked that out yet. But, let me take a look, and I'll see if Micah Hyde's still available.
Yeah, he'd be he turned into an all-pro when he left Green Bay.
Okay. Yeah. No. Yes, he did. Oh, yeah. Absolutely, he did. I appreciate it. Appreciate the phone call, Mike, as always, bud. And take care. That's a great question. I have not seen if Micah Hyde signed with anybody yet. So I'd have to take a look. I have not gone through the free agent tracker, so to speak. I'll get to it here in just a second. I'm trying to see who else is out there. I don't see. Let me go to corners. Okay, I'll find it in a second.
He's still on Buffalo. I don't know. He wasn't set to be a free agent. I think
Rasul Douglas was cut loose, but I don't think I didn't know if Micah Hyde was.
Well, Rasul Douglas came up at the end of his contract. Hyde is one of the few players they didn't cut on the back end of that defense.
There you go. So maybe that's what he's talking about. Because I'm like, I had to go look because I'm thinking, am I missing something here? Yeah, we talked about Tyron Smith, the tackle out of Dallas. And the concern for him is that he's missed quite a few games over the years. So I don't know if I'd be going in that direction. There's Trent Brown, the guy that came from came out of New England. He's another guy. He's big dude, man. He's 6'8". He's like Caleb Williams kind of big. But he has not been the quickest when it comes to pass rush. He's got just strength and power. But he's not the quickest when it comes to pass rush. Pass blocking, he rated, I can't remember what it was, but it was good. It wasn't great, but it was good. But if you're going to upgrade, you're going to get a bigger, unless you're going for depth. I think they're going to get an offensive lineman in the draft. That's what I think. Now we talked a little bit about a guy like Cameron Curl and a couple of the other safeties that are still floating around out there. That may be the direction you want to go in. If you're going to go with free agency, but beyond that, I don't see the Packers. I'm trying to think, of a middle linebacker that's out there. Maybe a guy like Devin White. I think Devin White's still available. I'm trying to think of who's out there, but I think Devin White was still available. Maybe a guy like that who has some sacks, can blitz the gap. He's a decent second level guy. And, but that's kind of it. I'm trying to think of other people that are out there that I've kind of made notes on. He kind of got cut loose too. I mean, not only was he, getting some money, but he didn't have a great season last year. Some seem to think that maybe he reached out. I'm just kind of looking at my notes, and some seem to think that maybe he reached his ceiling, so to speak. He didn't have as many tackles and such as much as an impact as he did in previous years this past season. So, but he's got 23 career sacks. He was drafted number 5 overall back in 2019. You would assume in the right system, maybe a little more aggressive type of system, maybe he becomes a viable option, but Devin White, the linebacker, might be a way to go if you want to go in that direction. But I still think that the Packers, if they do anything, it's probably going to be for another safety, maybe a middle linebacker. But I don't think they'll go into the free agent market, offensively speaking, unless they find themselves with a bargain. I mean, everybody loves a bargain, and the Packers are not, you know, adverse to signing somebody at a good bargain basement price, but I just don't see them doing much. I see them getting offensive line help in the draft because there are tackles that are going to – it wouldn't be a sexy pick on night one to pick up an offensive tackle, but because there is a good amount of tackles in this draft that are somewhat impressive, I could see them doing that. I could see them doing that in the first round. Or, God forbid, you trade back and you get a couple of picks because you've already got a plethora of them. You get a couple of picks where you can still get a quality offensive tackle and add another pick that maybe you can use later in a trade down the road to grab somebody you want. But, you know, again, that's neither here nor there. It's a lot of speculation at that point. 877-867-1670, 877-867-1670. If you want to hit us up, please feel free. Go ahead and give us a shout. 877-867-1670. Michael says, well, the Packers haven't had good luck with high-paid veteran defensive free agents in their signings in a while. Well, they did have luck. Don't get me wrong. Preston Smith and Zadarius Smith, Devondre Campbell, those were all good signings. Those were all quality guys when they brought them in. They didn't have longevity, but they all had quality years.
Amos, too.
Yeah, Adrian Amos was another one. He was solid, too. Michael says, has anybody made a move on A.J. Dillon yet? Nope. Trying to see here. There's some of the people that are saying a lot of stuff in the live stream. I was just seeing if there's anything that I missed. This one's from Brett. Again, he says, you know, why did they get rid of Aaron Rodgers and go with Josh Jacobs? Look, they got younger. Jacobs a beast. He just is. And he younger and for similar money, you get younger in speed. Younger, faster, you know? That's it. Younger, faster. And if you can do that for the same amount of money and bring down that age, they'll do it every time. The one thing we learned, we learn it every year, but we're always shocked when some things happen. But we always talk about it. Well, it's a business. It's a business. Yes, it is. It's a business. And we find that out every year. Every year. And this is the thing that the players, you know, fans want loyalty from players, but it's a business from the teams. Michael says, I agree with Preston Smith, but I can't consider one good season that great of a move, honestly. He's been steady. When he was opposite Zadarius Smith, they were used somewhat differently and they both were crashing the edges and they fed off one another. They just were used differently over the last couple of years. He was used differently even the numbers, when you look at the way, because they were so concentrating on, yes, they wanted to put pressure on the quarterback, but they were so concentrating on setting the edge. Don't do too much. Don't overrun. Don't go past. It's like we want you to be an outside edge rusher, but we're going to put some handcuffs on you. You know, sometimes you just got to be smart, right? So I think they kind of handcuffed him a little bit. I'm going to be really with Halfley saying, look, we're going to get pressure on a quarterback. We want to get after quarterbacks. We want to be more aggressive. When you've got a guy that says all of that, and if he utilizes those guys in that way, then you want to see what they have in the tank. Then you want to see if they have something in the tank where they can actually get after the quarterback a little bit. All right, let's do this. We're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back. And when we do, we're going to talk some Badger basketball, Big Ten basketball more so than anything. Zach Heilprin is down at the Big Ten tournament, and we'll pick his brain as to what's going on down there. So stay tuned for that. This portion of the program brought to you by our friends at Boondocks Barbecue Burgers and Brews and the store, the store in the back, because they have their own sauces, pies, cakes, all that kind of stuff, all locally serviced right out there from local dealers and local bakeries and such. A lot of good stuff at Boondocks Barbecue Burgers and Brews. They have a lot of good things coming up. Stay tuned. Stay tuned. They got a whole lot more. It's all coming up right after this. Stick around.
Ready? This is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Bill Michaels will resume in 5 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 4 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Bill Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Coming up tonight, they're going to be taking on Maryland. You got Michigan State, Minnesota going at it. Badgers coming up a little bit after that. Later on tonight, Ohio State and Iowa, and then wrapping things up over the in the late game, Penn State and Indiana. and Wisconsin and Maryland. Like I said, second game of the day coming up at 1 o'clock. We now go to Zach Heilprin, sports director, WOZN Madison, covering the Big Ten tournaments. Zach, how you doing, man?
Doing great, Bill.
So give me your thoughts on the Badgers heading into this one. It sounded like Greg Gard did not want to talk about the possibility of his team not being in the tournament, and even if they deserved to be there, it sounded like he didn't want to go there.
I mean, they're a lot to make the tournament. You know, when they beat Rutgers last week, gave them 19 wins. Everyone has them in, so I don't really – he didn't want to talk about it, but, I mean, it's been a while, you know. So, I mean, he knows. Like, at this time last year, he was stumping for them, thinking, saying that they needed to get in, and he doesn't need to talk about it this year because he knows they're in a good spot. But, yeah, I mean, it'd be great for them. I think we kind of talked about it last week. They needed that win over Rutgers. Not so much it was a need, but it was like a need because he needed some momentum going into this tournament. And so they get Maryland today, and if they can get by Maryland, they can take on Northwestern tomorrow. It's actually a pretty nice draw considering the way that Wisconsin has played down the stretch, you know, losing 8 of 11. But, you know, they're in a good – I think they're in a nice, you know, bracket for them came out. It's a nice bracket for them here in Minneapolis.
It was a loss, but I like the way they played against Purdue. You know, they get down early and then they battled back. And, you know, for most people that thought that they were going to get the doors blown off of them down in West Lafayette and such, and they didn't, and they played hard. And it's at one point in that game, they had it. They had a tie game. They had a 2-point game. I mean, they came battling back. I like the way, even in a loss, I like the way the season ended for them.
It's funny because I think you could make an argument that their best two games in this stretch, losing 8-11, were the two Big Ten games, were the two games against Purdue, right? I mean, Greg Gard thought they played well enough to win in the game at home. They lost that one by 6. And then obviously this one, they were within 4, you know, right down, not all the way to the wire, but with about 6 minutes left, they were right there. And they, you know, They fought. When they got down double digits, I thought they were going to get blown out. I think a lot of people thought they're going to get blown out, but they fought and put up a good enough fight. And he thinks, or you know, Greg Gard thought that they played better in that one than they did in the game in Madison. So yes, I think there's a little bit of positive momentum coming off the Rutgers game and the Purdue game, even though it was a loss.
What have they found down the stretch, if anything? Go ahead. What have they found down the stretch?
Honestly, Bill, I don't know that they found anything right now. I mean, they have the issues that they have are things that have been plaguing them throughout the year, and I don't know necessarily that they're ever going to get fixed this year. You know, defensively, the struggles. Now they've been better the last two games. So maybe we can point to that. Maryland's going to be a big test for them. Jameer Young is going to be a big test for them. But offensively, they still can't hit a three-pointer for their lives. They ended up shooting right around 33%. It's going to be one of the lowest percentages they've had in the last 20 years. They've had like a month where they're actually able to hit threes. If they start hitting threes, things look a whole lot better. But I think you could say that about maybe any team. But for me, it really comes down to Stephen Crowell. If you go and look at the analytics love Stephen Crowell. And when you look at the record, they're 14-4 when he plays at least 29 minutes. When he doesn't play, they're 5-8. You know, he plays less than that. And he hasn't been on the court enough in two of the last three games to make a huge impact because of foul trouble. So if he can stay out of foul trouble today and obviously tomorrow against Purdue or against Northwestern, then I give him a shot to win both these games.
The one thing that I noticed specifically in the game against Purdue, they pass up a lot of open shots. Does this team have confidence at all in their shooting ability?
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Do you think that they should have confidence in their shooting ability?
Yeah, well,
I feel like they've gotten beaten down a little bit. Now they'll never admit to that, and they'll say, "Yeah, the next shot's going in," but when the clanks start coming, I think it goes both ways. Like if everyone's hitting shots, it's kind of infectious and everyone else starts to hit shots. And when you're missing shots, it becomes that same thing. And there's a lot of doubt in your mind going in. Now you can say all the right things, but they have not been a very good shooting team all year from outside. And they have missed some, and they missed some open shots against Purdue for sure when they actually took them.
To answer your question, should they? I thought about this and I watched intently because I started noticing it more and more and more. they pass on open shots, and then as the shot clock winds down after passing up three or four, even five open looks, then they get rushed. They try to either dribble drive or try to find a contested step back just to throw it up. So, yeah, their shooting percentage is bad, but I think it's also in part because they don't take open shots. They wait too long. It's almost like I'm watching Gene Hackman in the movie Hoosier saying, you can't shoot until five passes.
Well, it's funny because we've talked about shot selection all year. Like, it has been a big thing that Greg Gard didn't like summer shot selection, and you wonder if maybe that's gotten into their head a little bit to the fact, you know, to the point where they are kind of like a little trigger reluctant, instead of being trigger happy, being trigger reluctant. And I think that kind of leads to that. And then it leads to the late clock situations, which of course you never want to be in. Those are not, very good for an offense to constantly be running down the clock all the time and throwing something up. That's not what this offense is about. And it's not what the offense has been about most of the year. So if you have an open shot, take an open shot. Greg Gard is not going to be upset with you for that.
Okay, let me ask you this, because you talk to Greg Gard all the time. So does Greg Gard philosophically have – so when you get into, hey, shot selection is not good and it can get into your guy's head, is there something specific he's looking for, or is it just where guys have just wailed it up rather than really kind of setting something up?
Yeah, I think a lot of it has to do with A.J. Storr and some of his decision-making in terms of three-point shooting instead of getting to the rim. Like, if you're touching the post and you're taking a contested shot, like, if you go down, you pass it once or twice, and then you put up a shot, even though you didn't really try and run any offense, that's going to be a problem for Greg Gard. And that is kind of not that's what A.J. Storr has done, I wouldn't say quite a bit, but a number of times. That's why he hasn't been overly efficient these last, 6 weeks, 7 weeks. He needs to take good shots more so probably than anybody else. But they obviously need to touch the post. And I know that is cliche. It's a huge cliche, but it's so true for Wisconsin. If they can play through Stephen Crowell, which with him being on the floor, they're just a much better team. Him and Tyler Wall down low, it's just such a better team when they are able to play through those guys.
Talking with Zach Heilprin, sports director, WOZN in Madison, our flagship station. Okay, say they get a win today and a win tomorrow. What do you think their seed ends up being? And if they lose this game, what do you think their seed ends up being? Or do you think it's set in stone at this point?
I don't think it's set in stone. I think it could go down one and could maybe go up one. A lot of people have them as a 6 or 7 right now. I think if they were to lose today, I think 8. Maybe 9's a little bit too negative, but 8 or 9 if they were to lose today. If they win these two games, I think 6 or 7 is probably it. So there actually is kind of could go up or down one slot based on how today and tomorrow go. I think. Again, now, well, not in that committee room, and I don't know what they're all taking into consideration and all that good stuff, but based on what everybody is, the experts that do this for a living, yes, and then also as a hobby, have them, 6 or 7 at this time.
Is this team, Zach, I'm going to ask you this only because Grant and I agree with that there's a level of frustration here. Is this team better than what their record shows?
Yes, but they also weren't as good as the number 6 team in the country. You know what I mean? Like, they are better than they have showed these last 6 weeks, but they are also not a team that I think was, in my mind, was ever Final Four like worthy. And if you're the number 6 team in the country and you're number 2 or 3 seed, well, then people think you're Final Four worthy. And I don't necessarily agree with that about this group. They have concerns. So are they better than they've shown? Absolutely. But they're also not what a lot of people thought they were going to be or could be, 20 games into the season.
How many teams do you think the Big Ten does get into the tournament this year? Because Indiana's right on their heels, only a game back, tied with Iowa and Michigan State for that matter.
Yeah, so it's kind of funny. Wisconsin's been considered a lock for how long now? Like, they were when they were 16-4, and everyone was. I think a lot of people thought they were a lock at that point, and they just never come off. So I think the only locks you could say right now are Michigan, Wisconsin, Illinois, and Purdue, and then there's 3 more that I think get in: Michigan State, Northwestern, and Nebraska. And I think, unless Iowa goes on a run here, I don't think they're going to get in. So it's probably going to be 6.
Okay.
And Indiana won't, unless they make a run. Unless they get that automatic berth. Which, again, anything can happen in this tournament because there's not a lot of great teams here Purdue's a really, really good team, and Illinois is playing well. But other than that, I think anybody can beat anybody.
Good stuff, Zach, and we'll touch base with you as the tournament gets underway, okay?
All right, sounds good, Bill. Thank you.
Appreciate it, pal. Talk to you later. There you go. Zach Heilprin, sports director, WOZN in Madison. Yeah, when you look at it, like he says, with Indiana, even though their record is very similar, you look at, you know, they lost to UConn. They lost to Auburn, an unranked Auburn team. They got beat by Kansas. But they lost to Nebraska. They lost to Rutgers, Purdue, Wisconsin, Illinois, Penn State, Northwestern, Nebraska yet again. They were beat twice by Nebraska this year. Penn State again. The teams they should have beaten, they beat. The teams that they could have had a good effort against, they didn't. And Indiana with RPI and all that kind of stuff, or whatever you want to, palm index, on the outside looking in. But even though they have a very similar record, on the outside looking in. So there you go. Good stuff, though, from Zach. Appreciate it as he is sitting there at the Big Ten tournament. Hopefully you get the Badgers to get a win. Because what you really want is the Badgers to get a win, feel good about yourself, your next game. Maybe you do knock off Northwestern, you know? Maybe you're playing basketball on Saturday. God forbid you're playing on Sunday, but maybe you're playing basketball on Saturday, right? You get a win. If you get one win, you're good. You know, get a good win, feel good about yourself, hard fought, either loss or win against Northwestern. But if you go to if you're playing ball on Saturday, you got to really feel good about where you're at and the way you see, because then you will have won three out of your last four and you're better in that circumstance. That's when you start to gain that confidence. Hopefully, because it's just, I watched this team on Sunday pass up a lot of open threes and a lot of open looks, only to get dribble drives into the height of Purdue and then try to dribble back out, or you get trapped, you're throwing the ball away, you're just tossing it up to toss it up. So yeah, it's not the best of circumstances for the Badgers right now, but if they get a little confidence, who knows, maybe they can do a little damage. So not a bad way to go. 877-867-1670. Find us if you choose to do so. Hey, our friends found us over at Veterans America, tremendous company. First of all, they've got a company, their parent company is called ProVisor, and they're a fantastic company, been around a long time here in the state of Wisconsin, but they started noticing more and more and more veterans, people in the military, military members, families that weren't getting the best of service. So they opened up a whole wing, a whole branch just dedicated to that. And they are certified. They have gone through the training. They find stuff that credit unions and regular banks and such don't. That's called Veterans America. And if you are a veteran, a military member, family member, you're looking to refi, looking for a mortgage, and now's not a great time. So you want to save all the money you possibly can. But that shouldn't prevent you from getting the most either out of your equity, out of your mortgage, whatever it happens to be. Call James Mercado, 262-745-3333, 262-745-3333. They really are big believers in owning the land that you've defended. It's 262-745-3333. That's 262-745-3333. That's Veterans America.
Ready.
This is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Make it a real Mad March with a playoff payout at Pottawatomie. Every week, you could score your share of 100 grand in cash and free play. Play this March for drawing entries. Win each Thursday. Plus, the prizes refresh every week for even more winners. The playoff payout at Pottawatomie, Milwaukee. It's anyone's game. For more details, visit paysbig.com/payout. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
0% interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. I'm Gina Della from Pella. Pella's free in-home consultations make replacing or redesigning your windows and doors easy. We go beyond just measuring and handing you a quote. We take the time to listen and educate you on all your product options. And with Design Works, you can see what your home will look like before you buy. Whether you're looking to replace your windows due to damage or it's time for a refresh and you'd like to revitalize your home style, choosing from Pella's wide range of windows and doors will complement your home's unique design. lapel can also customize, providing nearly endless possibilities for maximum design flexibility with dramatic sizes, custom colors, finishes, profiles, product types, and more. Order by March 31st to get 0% interest for up to 3 years. Set your free consultation at PellaWI.com.
Certain restrictions apply.
Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes. Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Have you been out and about lately and maybe you just needed something? Or maybe you're thinking to yourself, you know, tonight I'm in the mood for chicken. I'll tell you the place to go. Quick Trip. They've got it. Oh, yeah, they've got it. They've got all kinds of good chicken. And I've been telling you for a while, they've got all kinds of good stuff there anyway, whether you're heading in for just the staples. But the chicken, hand-breaded, prepared fresh daily. Daily, whether you get the bone in, 2 or 8 piece, or you get the boneless, the chicken tenders, hand-breaded, huge. Those things are huge, 3 or 8 piece. You can get them right now. And how about chicken for life? Because if you tasted it, you know how good it is. Chicken for life. All you got to do is go to quicktrip.com/friedchickenforlife and get all signed up. Wouldn't that be amazing to win fried chicken for life from Quick Trip? Oh, my God. I'd be in like this euphoric state. It'd be amazing. I'd be buying everything else from them, too. Stuff to wash it down with. But chicken for life. And it goes all the way through April 8th. So stop in or just simply go to quicktrip.com, quicktrip with a K, by the way, quicktrip.com/friedchickenforlife and get involved. But man, that stuff is prepared fresh daily. It tastes so good. And you're in there getting other stuff anyway. So stop in and check out our friends over there at Quick Trip. And who knows, maybe, maybe just going to Quick Trip gets you chicken for life. Chicken for life. I can't even tell you how good that would be. That'd be mind blowing for me. Be awesome. By the way, Rick just says, just ate a Quick Trip. Nature's Touch chocolate milk is absolutely the best. There you go. Good stuff. What else are we looking at here? I got a lot of people over on the live stream says, winning gambler says Big Ten sucks, may not get one team in the Sweet 16. You know what? But is that, I don't look at it as conferences. Because the mid-majors have stepped up, and it has been that way for a while. We've seen SEC teams that were supposed to win it all that don't. Big 12 teams, or Pac-12 teams even, that were supposed to win it all, and they don't. You know, every time the Big Ten gets four or five teams in, and then they get one team that gets to the Sweet 16, oh, the Big Ten sucks. Well, you can say the same thing about conferences that have failed in the past, right? You know, the Big East is supposed to be the biggest and baddest basketball conference on the planet. And they've struggled this year, too. You know, it's basketball has changed via the landscape. It's not the traditional. It's not the blue bloods as much anymore. It just isn't. The NIL has affected that. And because you can go to New Mexico State, be an absolute star, and get your team into the NCAA tournament and get a couple of wins. Because it's one of five. It's not one of 22 like football, where you're relying on the weakest link to be your strength, you know? So I don't necessarily go along with the Big Ten sucks. Is it as good as it used to be in domination? No, but even, you know, what was it, a year or two ago, they had like seven or eight, nine teams in, and still pretty much all of them were bounced and bounced early. We've seen this tournament loaded with upsets recently. Loaded with them. 877-867-1670. Another hour yet to go. Don't go anywhere. The Bill Michaels Show. We continue next.
Is a Wisconsin Sports Zone update.
Well, it's game day for the Badgers. They're in Minneapolis to play in the second round of the Big Ten tournament against Maryland. Terrapins took out Rutgers last night to advance. Wisconsin and Maryland played earlier this year in Madison with the Badgers coming out on top. Tip is coming up around at 1:30. The winner gets Northwestern in tomorrow's quarterfinals. Turning to the Bucks, they are also back in action tonight as the 76ers come to Fiserv Forum. Milwaukee coming back from a 1-3 road trip out west that saw them get blown out by 35 points in two of those losses. Coach Doc Rivers blamed their offense for the losses despite what they allowed defensively. Milwaukee comes into the game tied for second in the East with Cleveland and 9.5 games back of first place Boston. Tip is at 7. Meanwhile, Brewers got some bad news last night. ESPN reporting that closer Devin Williams going to miss 3 months with two stress fractures in his back. Reigning NL reliever of the year pitched with soreness last September, and it came back this spring. Pitched just twice this spring, allowing 4 runs in one of the third innings. Joel Piamps and Abner Uribe could serve as Milwaukee's closer while Williams goes through rehab.
Rural Mutual Insurance, keeping Wisconsin strong.
Rural Mutual is the number one farm insurer in Wisconsin for a good reason. As a company founded by farmers, they understand the ag industry and its challenges. Local agents offer farm families the best advice and personalized coverage. Visit ruralmutual.com to find an agent near you.
Rural Mutual Insurance, keeping Wisconsin strong.
Well, Wisconsin will hold its pro day tomorrow in Madison. Braylon Allen and Tanner Mordecai among the players slated to work out for NFL scouts. Allen expected to run the 40-yard dash after not doing so at the NFL Combine. Meanwhile, Packers made the release of linebacker Devondre Campbell official yesterday. He got off to a great start in Green Bay, all pro back in 2021, but his production fell off the last 2 years. With this Wisconsin Sports Zone Network update, I'm Zach Heilprin.
Good to have you on a Thursday edition. Rain falling, getting a little bit cooler outside. Not quite summer yet, getting close. But I will say one thing. It's amazing how much things and how much earlier things have begun to get green outside, right? I'm looking out the window here today and the backyard, the brown spots are pretty much gone. It's pretty much filled in by green. So it's good to see. Good to see the green coming in. Not bad. Hey, if you want to hit us up, 877-867-1670. Give us a call. You can find us over on Twitter on X at @Bill_Michaels, @Bill_Michaels, or find Grant Bills @Wisco Grant. You can also track us down via Instagram, The Bill Michaels Show. Four words, put them all together, The Bill Michaels Show. Same thing over on Facebook, facebook.com/The Bill Michaels Show. Same thing on TikTok as well. YouTube is a great way to pay attention to us. Always promoting that, and it's absolutely free. Even if you subscribe, it's free. Go to youtube.com/Bill Michaels Show, and you can find us there. Same thing on Twitch TV. If you have the Twitch app or the Kick app, LinkedIn, the same. Just simply Bill Michaels on LinkedIn, by the way. And then there's thebillmichaels@gmail.com. That's the web, or that's the way to email us, thebillmichaels@gmail.com. And the website, simply thebillmichaels.com, thebillmichaels.com. Take us anywhere and everywhere. So if you're Zach Heilprin, you're sitting down there watching the Big Ten tournament, oh, all you got to do is download the app and you can listen to us. Good to go. Find us on the app, The Zone Madison. And then afterwards, if you missed something, you want to tell your friends and neighbors what you heard, Spotify, Apple iTunes, Google Podcasts, that's a great way to find us also. So good stuff. By the way, before we were talking about Rasul Douglas, he ended up restructuring his deal to stay with Buffalo. So he is still there. Him and Micah Hyde still with Buffalo, with the Buffalo Bills. So had numerous people reach out, but I wanted to check on that. Sometimes, you know what? It's better the band of army, because I don't have every stat, statistics, player, and all that stuff sitting in front of me. So it's better the band of army and getting it done in the group. So thank you for those who were letting us know, because I had to go back and look too. 877-867-1670. Find us. This one is from Michael. Michael says, a couple of things. Tough break for Devin Williams. It only allows an opportunity now for somebody to step up. Hopefully, Pat Murphy has the Midas touch and Chris Hook is able to develop somebody into being that closer. It's going to take a little while, but by May, I would assume that the Brewers are going to know who their closer is. No worries on my part. Go crew. Can't wait for opening day. See you at Stenny's, which we are going to be at Stenny's opening day, the home opener, the Brewers home opener. We're going to be at Stenny's, second in National Walker's Point, so come on by and say hi. Yeah, we're going to be there for the home opener. So, good stuff. This one is from Jesse. Jesse says, Bill, is championship week your favorite week of the year? I would assume you're talking about championship weekend here with all the college hoops. That's a great question. God, I don't know. My favorite week of the year is or weekend or weeks, month, maybe. I don't know. I do love the NCAA tournament. I do love the beginning of baseball. So that all kind of gets combined into one, because usually baseball starts now before. It used to be baseball kind of like started always on April 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. And at the same time that you had the NCAA tournament culminating. But now it starts the week earlier, remember? So, yeah, it kind of is. I mean, I love football, you know? I love the opening day of the football season and getting into that, you know, when you start training camp, there's that 23-week jaunt from training camp till Super Bowl. That is a march. But For stuff that captures your attention every day and throughout for a three-week period, yeah, probably is. Probably is. Because you also know that when it comes out of the first week of April, you get into the Masters. So you go right from the tournament to baseball to the Masters. And we're a month away from the Masters. So, yeah, I probably would. I'd probably have to say that this is that time. That's a good question. I've never really thought about it in that sense.
I talked about this in October when the NFL was in full swing, college football in full swing.
Yeah.
Playoff baseball was awesome last year. It just kind of depends, I think, on what your favorite sports are. If you are a baseball guy or a college, because we all, for the most part, I think, love the NFL.
Yeah.
It just depends on what other sports really get you going. That probably impacts your answer.
I love the college football aspect of it, but this... And you're right. You've got baseball, you've got basketball starting, you've got football in full swing and college football in full swing. But there is something to be said about the excitement of the tournament. Because I'll sit down. Now, I'm a football junkie. I'll sit down and watch games. I don't have a problem with that. But when it comes to the tournament in college basketball, knowing that you've got, because in football, you're hardly ever going to see an Appalachian State knock off somebody to advance into a tournament. You know what I mean? You just don't see that. But in basketball, you could see it. It's a, you know, the tournament is the one and done, the excitement of the NCAA tournament. I can't put my finger on it. There's a different level of excitement. And I mean, all you had to do was start to watch over the last couple of days and watch the buzzer beaters. Oh my God. There was so many of them. It's so exciting to watch. And then you've got the highest of highs jubilation and the lowest of lows, just where you just had a dagger driven through your heart. So it's, man, what a massive experience that the NCAA tournament and championship week brings you. So I might have to say that might be my favorite. That might be. I do love postseason baseball, but the birth of baseball starting off, maybe it's because it's spring. You know, maybe it's because I know that right now, once we get through the NCAA tournament, which keeps us occupied now from now until the first week of April, then you get into baseball. You're still in the swing of free agency, and then you're getting into the Masters. This next 3, 4, 5 weeks that lead you into the warmer months, you can't beat it. There is so much going on. You can't beat it. And if you get any NFL news, you know, or you're starting to lead into really the NFL draft by the end of April, man, this is a good time.
I like college, but I like the tournament a lot, and I love watching the Badgers and the Big Ten. The problem for me is, you know, today and tomorrow, or I guess next week when the tournament starts, conference tournaments too, but like I would rather be home not doing a radio show. Whereas right. like there are other times of the year where it's like, man, we can talk about the Packers and the Bears and like, with this stuff, I just want to kick back and watch these random kids and random people. Like, I don't have anything to say on the radio about Vermont basketball.
Right.
It's just fun to watch. It's less fun to talk about. So that's my selfish radio host opinion.
Yeah. Like I said, I'm sitting here watching Texas Tech beat the hell out of BYU. Okay. You know, that's not a fun thing to witness. But, you know, when you start seeing, when you get to the tournament and you know there's an upset coming. Because we're all going to sit down and do brackets. I don't know if you fill out brackets, but I fill out brackets. I'm in everybody's tournament. And I usually try not to deviate too much. I try not to have like 20 different brackets out there because you never win if you do that. Stick with what your gut is. Stick with what you know. So I try to really kind of watch all of that and see the upsets. And I thrive on that because you know it's going to happen. The tournament has never gone scratch. You know it's going to happen. So I'd have to say that this is probably one of the most, if not the most exciting time of year. I love going to Super Bowl. So that's probably my favorite week. It's the hardest working week, but it's probably my favorite week. It really is. Going to the Super Bowl and enjoying that. That's, man, talk about a deep question. Made me think a lot. I think it's just because it's we're coming in the spring. I'm looking at rain, not snow. It's been warm. I've been able to get the motorcycle out. You got college basketball, the tournament on the horizon, baseball on the horizon. You know, you're in the midst of free agency for the NFL season. You know, I'm giddy right now. It's relatively euphoric. Hell, I didn't even leave yesterday. I sat here, did conference calls, had the basketball on in the background, watching some of these games. It was awesome. It was hard work, but it was awesome. Just loved it. 877-867-1670. Maybe you got a different opinion. Who knows? Let's see here. This is from Rick. Rick says, favorite time of year is when the Packers finally kick off. Marcy says favorite time of year is taking the kids up to see the Packers in training camp. Try to get there usually during the first week. LJ says my favorite time of year is the baseball playoffs. The Hunt for Red October is always awesome. Well, The Hunt for Red October was a movie, wasn't it? That was a movie.
Sean Connery
did that. I can't say Sean Connery without cracking up, because every time I do that, I think of the Saturday Night Live skits with Sean Connery. The caricature that played Sean Connery and Will Ferrell, who plays Alex Trebek. Like your mother did, Trebek. Oh, my God. I crack up at that every time I see it. But, yeah, I think that was the movie. So The Hunt for Red, unless, of course, you now in Cincinnati, it was always growing up, you know, The Hunt for Red's October. So that's what they always, you know, kind of shined with. But, oh, well. Kyle says, do you have the old Brewers song in your bevy of new banks of music? I do not. I should have, but I don't. I didn't think of it, but I should. I'll put it in there. I will. I got the Wisconsin Badgers fight song, Ahoya fight song from Marquette. I've got all of that stuff. I you're right. I didn't put the Brewers. I got Bang the Drum for the Packers. I didn't put the Brewers in there. So shame on me. I should have. That's an antiquated song, though. That's the one thing. The Brewers have not had anything updated when it comes to Brewers music, you know. Even the Bucks, you know, they've had different versions, Light It Up and all that kind of stuff, but they haven't had consistency there. But the Brewers, they've got that old the Brewers song. You don't have that, do you, Grant?
I mean, I can dig it up. I was just going to say that it's not surprising. They're still celebrating a team from 1982 that
right?
didn't win a title.
Right.
Like, if there was a team to not update their song, it would be the Milwaukee Brewers. And that's fine. I love them. We're losers, and
right.
I love it.
Right. Let me ask you this. The Cubs have won. So out of all the teams in Major League Baseball, who then could become the lovable losers? The Brewers have never won a championship.
It's still the Cubs. The Cubs are lovable losers. The Brewers are just losers. That's the only difference.
Oh, that's kind of a kick to the groin if I'm a Brewers fan. I'm just a loser. I'm not even lovable.
We're not asking for national respect here. We understand our place. Cubs,
yeah.
That's my frustration with Cubs fans, is they all of a sudden think that they're so high and mighty. They got counsel and they got expectations.
Yeah,
No. You're down here in the mud and the muck with us. You just have better branding.
Yeah, the only difference between you and us is you live in a craptastic city. That's it. Other than that, no. You know, you pay a lot more for stuff. So, yeah, I'm trying to... Who else in their franchise have never won a World Series?
It reminds me, I got to pay my Illinois tolls, by the way, in case of reminder. I'm going to do that after the show. I would never use Showtime to do that.
Oh, I do that. I do that 2 o'clock the show. Yeah, I do that. Otherwise, I'll forget about it. And then I think I got that stupid note from Illinois Tollways that starts to show up at your house. Nah, no, I'm not doing that at all. All right, let's do this. We're going to step out. We'll take a quick break. Let Grant pay his bills and then come back. Hey, if you're going to head down to the Fiserv Forum tonight, where are you going to go? Before or after? Calderon Club. Or San Giorgio, right next door. Either place, only a couple of blocks from the Fiserv Forum. Get terrific Italian food. Terrific Italian food. Spaghetti and meatballs, chicken marsala, fettuccine, whatever it happens to be, or just the thin crust pizza that they're so well known for as well. Or go to San Giorgio next door and get traditional Napoletana pizza over there. Either way, you can't go wrong. The best Italian food you're going to put in your grill. That's Calderon Club and San Giorgio right there on Old World 3rd Street, 838 Old World 3rd Street, right across the street from the Hyatt Hotel. Stop in, tell Gino and the gang we said hi.
This is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes. Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
By chance you are involved in any kind of a fender bender, or maybe you just want some body work done, whatever it happens to be, do not forget about our friends over there at One Collision County Line. They're in Menominee Falls, and if you're watching the live stream, that is my vehicle, and I got rear-ended, kind of. Somebody hit me on the rear quarter, the bumper cover, the rear passenger door, and Got it all fixed, but it's like brand new. It was like when I got the car back, it was like the day it came off the showroom floor, and they did a fantastic job. Even fixed the wheel without having to replace that whole thing. They even fixed the wheel, got all the gunk and everything off of it from their tire, and it was awesome. The job they did, and the fact that they keep you up to date every step of the way. And let you know what your car is doing, whether it's in paint, whether it's doing body work, whether they're waiting on parts, whatever it is. They text it to you, so you know what day and when you're going to go be able to get your car, what time. It's going to be done in the morning, going to be done in the afternoon. It was a flawless and seamless process. So One Collision County Line, they work great with insurance companies, great with you when it comes to your deductible. And they really are professional and really good. One Collision County Line, Menominee Falls, Wisconsin, 262-251-1700, 262-251-1700, 262-251-1700. That is One Collision County Line. Great people and even better service. Just really, really good. Really, really good stuff. 877-867-1670. Winning Gambler said the Brewers are definitely a cursed franchise for sure. Are they cursed?
Oh yeah.
Do we look at it that way? Do we say, are they cursed? We really do.
I've just said for the last couple of years that God just doesn't like them for whatever reason. I don't know if there's like a curse of a Billy Goat or a fan like Steve Bartman. I just don't think God smiles upon our Milwaukee Brewers. Yeah. I don't even know if it's a curse.
I think what the problem with the Brewers is, it's not necessarily a curse. It's the curse of being in the market they're in, monetarily, where you just don't have the ability to get that extra guy sometimes, you know? How many organizations can you look at and have that be said where you're rolling and you're playing really well? And because the curse wasn't getting rid of Josh Hader. They did that to themselves. So you can't say that. The year that they finally got back into the postseason with CeCe was, he just willed them across the finish line. They had a few injuries, but, you know, and Ben Sheets obviously going down. But I don't know if I'd say they're cursed. You know, maybe Devin Williams punching a wall and breaking a bone in his hand, or, you know, the fingertip. Remember the fingertip of Ben Sheets? They're going to the postseason and Ben Sheets comes up with a busted up fingertip because he was rock climbing with his kid. That never came out. That was never made public right away, but that's kind of what I heard happened. I think it's more the small market thing, you know? There's not many small market teams that have won championships consistently or numerous. You know, I'm trying to think. Kansas City won and then broke it all up. Cincinnati won one back in 90. But, you know, their championships prior to that were in 75 and 76. And that was before free agency. Because there's no way in hell you'd ever put a team like that together in today's day and age. There's no way. That machine, that big red machine team was just phenomenal. Dominated. But I'm trying to think what other small franchises have won consistently. You know what I mean? We know the Yankees have had consistent wins, but ever since, you know, they run into some issues and they lose some of their greats, they haven't been a consistent postseason champion. Houston has figured it out and had some of their contracts where they could bring guys up.
The Astros are really the only team, small market, big market, whatever, that's had consistent championship series, World Series berths and wins. Like the Yankees and the Dodgers haven't, not since the 90s for the Yankees.
Well, they haven't had consistency. You can look at, Winning Gambler says, what about Woodruff's injury before last year's playoff? The latest injury, you know, yeah, okay.
Burns in 2020 and Williams in 2020. And then again in 2021, Jesus.
But I think about all these other teams that have also had problems. You know, they've had guys go down in August and they don't make the stretch run or their season comes to an end or whatever. You know, it's, you gotta be good. You got to be lucky, you got to be healthy, and you got to be hot. And I believe that in every case of every sport, that those four things have to come into play and have to align all at the same time for you to win a championship. You know, even when the White Sox done it, you know, when the White Sox won, everything came together for them. Same thing with Kansas City, everything came together for them. You know, there's a little bit of luck there that's involved with that, but. You know, I thought the Brewers were one of the best teams in baseball when they faced the Dodgers in the NLCS, and they couldn't hit their way out of a paper bag after they'd been hitting anything and everything that teams were throwing up against them. And all of a sudden, everything just went cold. It wasn't because of mass injury. It was just because their offense couldn't swing a bat. You look at the game against Washington. They had a couple injuries going into that game, but it was a one and done, and it was an error. They had an error. It wasn't because they couldn't compete. It was they had the game won, and they had an error. Throwing error, a bobble in the outfield, and a throwing error, and next thing you know, you're down, and the game's over. I don't know if I'd call them cursed. I would just simply say that it's a small market team that's trying to compete with the big market teams, and the teams that have gone on to win championships have been the teams that have ultimately beat the Brewers. Maybe there's something to be said in that. I don't know. But at least they're there. A lot of teams you can't even say that about consistently. That's the one thing about the Brewers is they've been there consistently. 877-867-1670, 877-867-1670. What else do we have here for you? Let's see here. I think this is Canty. Canty said, C-A-N-T-Y. Canty says, are you going to get out to many games this year in the Northwoods League? Would love to have you back up with the Wisconsin Woodchucks. Do you still travel around and do some stadium stuff? I haven't, not over the last couple of years. As a matter of fact, I just saw something cross for the – I had a little cross loggers pullover on yesterday. And today there was an invite. Now, it was to me – and did you get it too, Grant?
Yeah, it was cross logger to my calendar.
Yeah.
Because they normally do a WKTY night. So I've been there the last two summers. Okay. And you and Ebo are always welcome as well.
Yeah.
Normally it's a Sunday afternoon game.
Yeah. I got that a little bit earlier today. I'd do that. I don't know what I know they gave a couple of dates, but I'd do that. If I'm free, I'll do that in a heartbeat. I loved, you know what, when I would go and do the affiliate visits and we could get to some of the Northwood League games, loved it. Absolutely loved it. Loved going and watching. I, you know, sometimes I stay for the entire game, man. Hot dog, popcorn, couple of beverages. That was me. Sometimes you had to get out of there. You had to get moving, but I'd still stay for three, four, five innings. And I love that brand of baseball. And the fact I've seen some Milwaukee Milkmen games, the Dachshunds are out here now, which are close to my house. The Chinooks, the Kingfish. So to answer your question, I love doing that. I'd like to get out and do that a little bit more this year. Heck yes. In a heartbeat. So there you go. Let's do this. We'll step out. We'll take a quick break. We'll come back. A couple of segments yet to go. We'll wrap things up today. In case you missed Tim Allen with us a little bit earlier today, and some of you are now peeling off to watch Badger basketball, what have you. But we had a good discussion regarding the Brewers, and Tim's always a wealth of information. So we're gonna replay that coming up here in a couple of segments. Stay tuned. We got more of the Bill Michaels Show coming up right after this.
This is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Bill Michaels will resume in 5 minutes. Michaels will resume in 4 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes.
Phil Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Glad you're on board with us. Hey, if you are thinking about getting away, whether it's to an all-inclusive, maybe you want to take a cruise, head to Vegas, maybe a sports trip, you're going to take some time off and go check out Brewers baseball or something somewhere, or maybe you want to go internationally, a trip of a lifetime. Whatever it is, Dream Vacations, they can help you out. 414-208-4221, 414-208-4221. Michael and Melissa, great people. They work great with veterans as well. So they're very much a philanthropic entity when it comes to dealing with veterans. And they even waive some fees if you are in the military or a veteran family. So give them a shout. Again, 414-208-4221 for resort needs, cruise needs, sport travel vacations. Let them help you book it, or just a trip of a lifetime. And you can even put some money down. You can finance it. There's so many options they give you. But again, call them 414-208-4221 anywhere in the state of Wisconsin. I just had a friend of mine who had emailed me. Actually, he said, hey, I know you deal with a couple of different travel agents. Can you hook me up? And he wanted to go to Greece and got him actually. And he lives in Ohio. He got a better deal through Michael and Melissa if they even drove here or flew here to fly out of Mitchell or fly out of Chicago than it would have been to fly out of Greater Cincinnati Airport, and said to save me about $800. So they can help you out. Melissa and Michael, they do a lot of great work. Again, 414-208-4221. That is Dream Vacations. Just give them a shout. Let's see here. Rich says, does the Zone app carry Grant's show? Yes, they do, as a matter of fact, right, Grant? Zone app does, yeah.
That's the best way, and it's the same with your show, because individual affiliates might have the Brewers, they might have the Zone app. If the show is on, it's going to be on the Zone app, always.
There you go.
That's true of your show and my show, so that's a good way to do it.
So always a good way to follow. So yes, to answer your question, there you have it. Let's see here. What else do we have for you? This is Mark, who says, I'm excited for Brewers baseball, but I'm more excited to see Craig Counsell fail. Tell Grant I'm right there with him. We are going to walk in lockstep in the hatred for one Craig Counsell. Thank you very much. So he's right there with you, Grant.
I'm glad I'm not alone. That's all I'll say.
I don't have hatred. Hatred's a strong word, man.
Yeah.
You know, if Craig walked up to you today, you'd still talk to him. You'd still be cordial. You'd still be nice. You'd still love to interview him. You'd still love to talk to him. You just don't hope that they have success. Correct me if I'm wrong. It wouldn't be like Craig, you go, hey, Grant, you know, how you doing? I'm Craig Counsell. Nice to meet you. It wouldn't be like you'd go, take that hand and wipe my butt. You know, you wouldn't scream at him like that, right?
No, Lord. Okay. No, he's a human being. I don't hate him as a human being, as a sports entity. Like, I just gets my gears grinding. Okay. That's all. No, I don't hate. Hate's a strong word.
Hate's a strong word, man. Come on. There's not much in this world that I hate. You know, circumstances, maybe hate is used too often, much like, you know, great is used too often. But I can see the anger there. But come on, we're not getting into hatred here. Let's see here. What else do we have here for you? This is this is Mark. Mark says, hey, guys, I love listening to the program. I love it when the show goes off the rails and you guys start talking about goofy stuff. The whole Thin Mint discussion the other day about whether or not to freeze them had my wife and I in an argument in the car. I wanted to thank you because it's the first time I've ever won an argument with my wife. Other people actually freeze Thin Mints. Thank you. Okay. All right. Well, there you have it. I don't know if we necessarily settled anything, but you know, just you always have to keep that one box back. Keep it back for summertime. It's always a good way to go.
The Badgers have hit their first three-point attempts. So I was watching it. A little bit of the confidence we need.
I was watching that. So who knows? I'm kind of giddy, kind of excited right now to see if the Badgers can do something. And then this one's from, who's this from? We already read Ricky's. Here's Jeff. Jeff says, hey, unit. Not happy so far with the offseason for the Green Bay Packers. I thought they were going for a championship. Instead, do you think they really bettered themselves or just got rid of money? Isn't this about winning championships at this point? You keep talking about the window being open. Jeff, I think they did get better. They got better at safety. They got a younger. Even if, let's just say Josh Jacobs is the exact same as Aaron Jones, but a little bit faster with breakaway speed. You got him younger and about the same price. And you're not paying $12 million out this season. So you cut you cut your salary and you got better. There's none of it, you know. No, I think they're a better football team, and I think they're actually going to do some good things. Let's do this. We're going to step out, take a quick break. When we come back, Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show. If you didn't hear it from a little bit earlier, we talked with him about the loss of Devin Williams. If you're just tuning us in and waking up today, Devin Williams, the closer for the Milwaukee Brewers, out for at least 3 months. He has small fractures in his back, some hairline fractures in his back, stress fractures, they call them. And he is going to be down for a while. So it's disappointing. It's somewhat heartbreaking. But, you know, you hope that he's able to come back. And if the Brewers can sustain in the meantime, then, you know, when he comes back, you knock on wood that he's just as good. And this thing all matriculates forward and they end up having a winning season. So don't give up on them just yet, just because you get a little bit of bad news. Let's do this. We'll go ahead and take a quick break. We'll come back and we'll get back into this. Hey, some good friends came on board as a sponsor, Levine and Iceburner, personal injury attorneys. I know Brent Iceburner personally. He's a really good guy. Estate planning, wills and trusts and all that kind of stuff, or civil litigation if you have defamation or business and contractual issues. But they do so much good work, and they also veterans, just so you know. Brent's a veteran. So if you're looking for somebody that's good, disciplined, military background, 608-621-2888, 608-621-2888, anywhere in the state of Wisconsin, and they can help you out. They're just good people, okay? Levine, Iceburner, give them a shout, 608-621-2888. More of the Bill Michaels Show coming up next.
Covering Wisconsin sports like a blanket, this is the Bill Michaels Show on the Wisconsin Sports Zone Radio Network.
Make it a real Mad March with a playoff payout at Pottawatomie. Every week, you could score your share of 100 grand in cash and free play. Play this March for drawing entries. Win each Thursday. Plus, the prizes refresh every week for even more winners. The playoff payout at Pottawatomie, Milwaukee. It's anyone's game. For more details, visit paysbig.com/payout. Must be 21 and a club member to play.
We'll be right back.
Bill Michaels will resume in 3 minutes. Michaels will resume in 2 minutes. Bill Michaels will resume in 1 minute. Bill Michaels will resume in 30 seconds.
Have you back. If you are out in the La Crosse area, maybe Jackson County, Vernon, Monroe, Trempealeau, Onalaska area, Every Plumbing and Heating, Craig Every has taken what his grandfather started, which was Clayton Every, the Korean War veteran back in 1969, and his dad had it. Now he's got it, third generation. They continue to grow, continue to get bigger, better, concentrating on a lot of the plumbing needs out in that area. They said they've gotten a lot of calls, whether it's bathroom renovation or new construction, renovation construction, putting in water softeners, putting in water heaters. This time of year, you know, you start to get some people that turn on the hoses and all of a sudden they find out that maybe the spigot is kind of cracked. So whatever it may be, Every Plumbing and Heating, they do it all. And they've got some new licensed plumbers that are really, really good. Call them 608-783-2803, 608-783-2803, Every Plumbing and Heating out in La Crosse, 608-783-2803. Really good people and really good. It was a Korean War veteran that started it, a veteran run started business that's been around a long time. Family business been around a long time. 608-783-2803. Earlier today, we had a chance to catch up with our buddy Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show. And I talked with him, started out talking with him about, obviously, you know, the Milwaukee Brewers and, you know, it's tough. You lose a guy like Devin Williams. You got some injuries, but all in all, you know, it's not snowing, and we're getting ready to talk about opening day baseball, so that's not a bad thing. Here's Tim Allen from earlier today. Joining us now on the hotline, our guy Tim Allen, host of the Baseball Postgame Show on 97.3 The Game in Milwaukee. Tim, how you doing, buddy?
Well, yeah, I'm standing outside in my slippers, and unfortunately, it's rain coming down. You're right. It's not snow. What do they say? March and April showers in Wisconsin brings mud until June. So we got that to look forward to. So I'm standing outside, and of course, walk the dog. You know what that's like. You walk the dog, and you loose right into the biggest puddle you can find. And so now my feet are cold, and well, we'll warm you up with some Brewers conversation.
So let's start with Devin Williams, and it's not the kind of conversation we wanted to talk about, Tim, but he goes down with stress fractures in his back, and that's never a good thing. And I knew the minute they said they're going to see a specialist, it wasn't going to be good news, and sure enough, we got some of the worst possible. So give me your thoughts on the back end of the bullpen now.
Well, you know, we're seeing it more and more, Bill, that, you know, immediately last night on social media, and I know you saw it too, that a little bit of controversy there. And it's like, well, Brewers said that, you know, it was nothing major, and then he wanted a second opinion. I think we've learned a few things over the years. I think both professionally and in the sports world, that it's okay to get this. This is why you get second opinions. It's not the scoff. It's not the, you know, really knock anybody's specialist, but a second opinion is okay in the medical world, not only professionally in that sports world, but I think in our personal lives too. It's okay to get the second opinion. You want that. It's, you see other sides of the story. So we wanted to, you know, I would like to put that to rest. And I don't look at it as controversial. I just look at it as, you know, it's, he's a human being. He wants another opinion. He's entitled to that right. So what does it mean for the Brewers? Well, it's not like Freddie Peralta, Wade Miley. The news seems to be getting better and better. You didn't lose a workhorse like Colin Ray. You lost a guy that is wicked. Don't get me wrong. One of the best, if not the best, in baseball. 36 saves, 1.5 ERA. But it is a department of strength for this baseball team. So to find that sort of silver lining here, Bill, I think is one thing to key on. Now, who's going to close? Well, they're out-getters, as counsel taught us years ago. Is it one of the younger guys? Is it Uribe? You got a control issue there, throws hard, nasty stuff. Is it McGill? Throws hard, nasty stuff. But again, control might be a little bit of an issue. My guess is they're going to go with Pyomps. I think it's a safe play there. And I think he can get on a roll and kind of capture that closing spot.
That's what I hinted to a little bit earlier. Now, here's the other question. And you know that the arm that everybody's talking about down in the minors is Mizorowski. And, you know, it would be great if they could bring him up at some point and he really becomes that guy, because Uribe can throw hard, but he doesn't throw for strikeouts on the continuum. If Mizorowski could come up and maybe make a little hay in the back end of that bullpen, that wouldn't be a bad way to go. But you don't put a rookie in a closing situation automatically. You know what I mean?
You know, you're right. And they're going to bring him along a little bit on the, you know, maybe predictable side. And that is kind of ease him in. Look what they did with Burns and Woodruff. You know, they worked those guys in right around what, 17, 18 range. And that seemed to be sort of the cardinal way of things. They would always start their starters out in that bullpen, get their feet wet a little bit, learn how to travel, learn the Major League Baseball protocols, and it relaxed them more, and they turned into great stuff with Mizorowski. But, you know, there's another guy in camp there, Brian Hudson, who is a big, tall one, I think the tallest in Brewers history, I want to say, or at least tied with maybe a Cameron Lowe or a Richie Sexton or someone. But he's a guy that's got nasty stuff. And so you might find this bright little surprise. And then when Devin does ultimately come back, you may have found another guy that you say, hey, yeah, we got surprised with a negative, but look at this. Look, it created a surprise on the positive. So that end of the story here, Bill, is that bullpen, it's got some, they were the second best bullpen in all of baseball last year. Mm-hmm.
Right. They've got some nastiness out in that bullpen, and I don't, you know, are they gonna regress just a little bit? Maybe, but they're not gonna hit the floor. There's too much talent out there.
Right. Give me your thoughts on Bryce Durang. Seemed very optimistic. He no more than gets dubbed the starter, goes out and goes 3-for-3. Looks as if he's got a little bit better poke so far this spring training. Give me your thoughts on Bryce Durang and maybe if what he can give you at the plate.
Came in a little bit more beefed up, a little bit muscled up. You got to do better in .218 with your batting average, and he's on a quest to do a little bit better than that. Mate, I think he has earned, Bill, and he's outstanding with the glove. We all know that. Gold glove caliber guy. So we don't have to worry about that. But you know, he's got a hit for a better average, a better on base. He just does. And so I think he's earned the start. And Murph said the other day that, hey, he's our second baseman. Now you do have the backup plan. You've got a Monasterio out there. You've got, if you need, a Vinny Capra at this point, Arroyo. So you've got some moving parts there to cover it. But you've invested this much time. Give him the go here early on. Give him half a season. Let's see what he can do, and maybe he'll surprise us.
Thoughts on Rhys Hoskins? Because I look at Rhys Hoskins, William Contreras, also Christian Yelich. Those are your top guys. Those are your elder statesmen, so to speak. Guys looking to either come back from an injury or extend what they did last season. On one hand, I look at it and go, hold your breath. On the other hand, I'm kind of excited about this. I'm excited to see what Christian Yelich, a little bit more bulked up Christian Yelich can do. A little more poke so far in spring training. Hoskins is certainly looking the way he's supposed to look and maybe what he can return to from a couple of years ago. Give me your thoughts on the veterans there.
Yeah, no, and you know, the one that we don't talk about, he's still there. Hello, people. There's Willy Adames here.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
Everybody's talking about Hoskins and Contreras, and rightly so. No question, Contreras, my goodness, they have found a good one, and I think we're just scratching the surface for what this kid is, and he's still young, Bill. It's amazing. So you get some certainty at first base with Hoskins. Now, again, this is, you know, really stating that, you know, the injury is going to be behind him. So if he, as you said, if he comes back to what he was, at least you got some steadiness there. You don't have to flip-flop around and have 68,000 first basemen since Prince Fielder left.
Right.
But, yeah, now on the other side, you have the younger guys. So here's what needs to happen for this offense to be – you know, 11th in the league or something like that. You know, upper third. They have to have two of the young guys splash. They just do. And if they don't, then this offense, the muscle guys you just talked about, can only do so much. They need Furio, Mitchell, Frelick, and maybe a Weimer, maybe another guy that comes up, a Tyler Black. They need two of those guys to splash, like, oh man, look at this. And that being said, apparently Murph thinks it's Sal Frelick. And because they think so highly of Turio and Mitchell, there's not enough room out there. Yelich isn't coming out of left field. So you have to find a place for one of those. The DH, maybe a Sanchez, you know, you're gonna have some moving parts there. But Frelick, Murph said the other day, we have not put enough emphasis on Sal Frelick at third. And quote, it'll be one of the best stories in all of baseball is the Sal Frelick move to third base.
Right.
So two of those guys got a splash and they've got to hit. And you get those high round draft choices. There's enough talent there that, you know, you can't catch and hear these guys. You got to hit on some of these guys,
right,
and hopefully it's two of them.
Well, that's my next question, because you mentioned Willy Adames. First of all, he gave you the power numbers last year, but he's got to get a better, you know, batting average. You and I are still old school in believing that a batting average absolutely matters, yep, in some way, shape, or form. So he's got to give you a better batting average. And last year, the batting average and the struggles at the plate, even though he gave you power numbers, seemed to affect him in the field a little bit too. So that's another guy that if he gives you a little more splash, a little more pop, or even, you know, a better on-base percentage, I think also he's a guy that can really kind of help you out as well. And you're right. We don't talk about him enough, man.
No. And you know what? For those that believe in walk years, contract years, call them what you want. It's where Willie is. And Willie is, you know, is he going to bet on himself? Are the Brewers going to say, hey, we'll offer you an extension? And then even that, that's a, you know, offensively speaking, that's a risk, because if you don't get that batting average up, that means your on base is going to stay at 300 to 90 something. And that's just unacceptable. And he knows that. I was watching the game the other night, and he's swinging at low and outside stuff. And it's like, Willie, you got to take your walks, man. You got to make him pitch to you. And so hopefully that'll happen, but he's got to bring the batting. I'm with you, man. You and I have been in lockstep for well over a decade here. A batting average at least means you're getting on base through hitting, and then you're going to take your walks, which then in lies your raised on base percentage. So it all emanates from there. I'm not opposed to OPS. I mean, OPS is a great stat too, but it starts with getting on base, and starting with getting on base, you can't walk every time. So you got to hit your way on and get yourself an average. So
there you go. That's Tim Allen from a little bit earlier today, talking a little Brewers baseball. And we're just about ready to get out of here. I want to let you know that you've got to the Badgers tonight right now, 33-15 with 7:59 left to go in the first half. They are up on Maryland. Got off to a fast start and been playing pretty well. So 33-15 over Maryland right now, the Badgers are. Earlier today in the Big Ten tournament, 77-67. Michigan State knocked off Minnesota to advance as well up in Minneapolis. And you've got Marquette basketball coming up 8:30 tonight, taking on Villanova. The Bucks are back at home in the Fiserv Forum. They got the 76ers in town. And trying to get a win there. So there you go. Whole lot of basketball. Whole lot of basketball. Stay dry. It's kind of coming down out there. Stay dry and enjoy. Stay in, for God's sake. Stay in and just enjoy hoops tonight. Or today, for that matter. So good stuff. That's it. That'll do it. Until we come back tomorrow and we talk some high school hoops tomorrow. With Scott Emmerich, the voice of Wisconsin high school state basketball. Get into that, and 20 hours from now, we'll be back up to discussion.